Good. Okay, here we are. Welcome to another episode of Grab Bag, where we do, you know, who the hell knows sometimes, and just see how it goes. We have today Paul and James, illustrious game designers for today, and we're gonna mash up Mage Knight, Suro, and Loot, and, you know, we're gonna see how it goes. It's always kind of scary, but... You guys feeling all right about it?
I'm pretty good at smashing.
Yeah, we're not
together.
Scared.
Not
yeah.
scared at
Maybe
all?
Maybe you should be scared.
but I'll give you guys a chance to introduce yourselves and talk about your game design kind of resumes.
Go ahead.
Okay, I'm Paul Peterson. Probably best known for Guillotine and Smash Up. Those are my current hits, I guess. Although Guillotine's really old to be a hit, but...
people still love it.
They still sell, so that's good. Lately we just finished a Kickstarter for the Ninth World Numenera card game and Running with the Bulls and
awesome.
Yeah.
Cool. Very
nice.
Thank you.
I'm James Ernest. I'm from Cheap Ass Games and I'm well known for about 100 different games,
yeah.
But I've done some work with Paul
That's
as
right.
well. We did Unexploded Cow together.
That's right.
You helped me with a game for Wizards of the Coast.
I did.
When neither of us worked there yet, or you were in customer service.
Was...
This was back in 1993.
Which one?
Hero.
Oh, Hero. Yeah,
right?
Yeah, yeah. Yep.
Right. We pitched a trading card game to Wizards.
For kids.
Yeah, for kids. Yeah. We thought that would be a good idea.
Well,
before Pokemon,
someone figured
yeah,
out how
yeah,
that worked.
Yeah, yeah.
But okay, cool.
So yeah, Paul and I have been designing games together for 20 years.
Yep.
Awesome. Well, this should be a piece of cake then.
22 years.
22 years.
Great. So happy to have you both here, and y'all certainly know a lot more about this than I do. So
well, tell us what you want us to do.
We'll see how this goes. So what we're gonna do? Okay. So we have this has been voted on previously. So what we're working with today. We're working with the cards from Loot, which is almost all cards anyway, so that will be that.
Basically the whole game.
The whole game. We're working with the board from Suro. I believe it's here already. Feel free to use anything else in here that you like on top of that.
All right.
And then we're also using the figures from Mage Knight.
Now, I opened this copy, and there are not very many figures in there, so I'm not exactly sure. We'll figure something out.
Let's
get
this
in there.
Is why people tune in,
I'm
Paul.
Starting off...
The hot puns.
I think I'm gonna use as our game title something that you said to describe the show itself, which is mildly frightening gamble. That should either be the game or the mechanic.
It describes my life lately, so
I think that's an album actually.
So get out the figs if that's
sure,
all we need.
Pull
out
them
of
all
this.
Out. I mean, you have to use the figurines. That's mandatory, but the rest is optional. So there's a lot of stuff in here actually.
Well, I like stuff, but stuff is distracting, right? I don't. Designing a game around a toy is hard enough without throwing in extra toys.
Hidden in here somewhere. Because this is a Mage Knight, you'd think that there were
these
like
are cool
a million
boxes.
You think
those
there were
boxes,
a million figures in
those
here?
Little rock things,
tessellating hex tiles,
blue math or whatever that is.
Blue math.
Honestly, these appear
Breaking
to be
bad.
the miniatures
this is,
in this.
This is this is called crystal core math. Actually.
Crystal core math.
All right.
We got some crazy cards here.
Well.
Alright, so we got the figures. Which
I'd be willing to bet when people voted to
castles,
use the figures from Mage Knight, they didn't.
They thought there were more figures than
they,
Mage Knight.
They assumed
they
it was
have.
The war game that has like.
Well, no, I mean, so this is a good collection of figures though,
yeah,
because
that's
it's like castles, which are like home bases,
mm-hmm.
and figurines that might be associated with those castles. I can almost draw the parallels. Yeah, there we go.
We got some loot cards, which I've never played this game, but it's just pictures of ships.
It's two categories
with
of numbers.
Some
there's,
numbers and stuff.
There's numbers in the corner. I think this is 1 through 8
uh-huh.
for gold,
and 1 through 4, 1 through 5 for pirates.
Okay.
Yar.
So those are
let me
gold
check
and
the numbers
pirates
on this thing.
What have we got in here?
Well, obviously we have the
we got the board.
Tiles.
We got these tiles.
We've
this
got the stones if we want
might
them.
Might be useful.
Scoring track always useful.
Mm-hmm.
Is that what this is?
I think so. I assume so.
Yeah. But, we may not use that, we'll see, I don't know.
Yes.
Oh, I see.
I'm not sure why it's broken up into sevens, but I'm sure there's a reason.
It's not broken into sevens. It's,
oh, no.
Break a seven to 14, 23, 34, 47. These
have access to
the spaces are getting smaller because they, on average, have to hold fewer people. That's my guess.
Okay. But that's irrelevant because that's not what we're doing.
Okay, so.
Yeah, this isn't acquired component.
I'm just throwing it out as a suggestion. What do you
that
guys...
would be awesome, and you have to use the scorecard from this game.
What are you guys thinking about?
The numbers 1 through 100, you say.
Interesting.
Given these components, what, anything come to mind right away?
Paul.
a million things.
Yeah, nothing comes to mind for me because I hate designing the components. Like, this is a fun idea, right?
Okay.
But like, when people bring me a toy and they're like, make a game with this toy, I just want to punch them in the face. Only because I've done it 100
times. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Right?
Only because you're tired of it, not because...
No, because it's never good.
Right.
Because
right.
It never produces anything fun. Like, if you, they bring me, for example, a guitar controller from Rock Band and say, make a game with this that isn't Rock Band. I'm like, well,
this is
what?
Not quite the same as that. We've made some fun games on the show.
I agree. But I'm not inspired by these pieces.
I see. Well, I didn't ask... Okay, that's fair.
I enjoyed Stonehenge a lot and enjoyed working on it. Well, fine. You didn't.
Stonehenge proves... What we already thought was true, which is five games that are 20% good are not worth the same as one game that is 100% good.
Okay, well, given those reservations, given those mild reservations, do you have any game designery inspirations or begrudging, you know, mechanics that you hate but are spilling out of your brain anyway? You can hate it, but I just want to know what it is.
Well, I always want to know what a game's about, right? If it's a gambling game, it's about that. It's about risk and reward and winning money and... if it's a strategy game, then it's about that. And it's about planning and understanding what's going on.
Okay.
And so, Paul, what kind of game do you think you want to make? Well, if it's called Mildly Frightening Gamble, I have a suggestion, but it doesn't have to be called that.
Mildly Frightening Gamble, that's a good name.
What happens on the you die space?
You die, obviously.
Does that mean you're out of the game?
You think deeply about death and then go back to your room and fall asleep.
Exactly. Well, the cards seem like they're made for some sort of set collecting. I'm sure that they probably were originally, there's enough different suits-ish.
But hold on a second. I will countermand that suggestion. Okay. I believe the suits... No, you're right. There are suits.
Yeah.
Son of a...
Oh, there are. And so, in the form of colors.
Yeah,
sure.
So in the form of colors with no secondary indicator. But sure, if you're not colorblind, there's suits.
Mm-hmm.
So there are the numbers 1 through 4, and they are also in, I'm going to guess... Four colors. At least four colors.
Okay.
But there are not suits in the money cards. Those are just numbers.
Right, but they might be in another suit depending on how many there are.
What?
This is definitely out of place, right? This little pirate guy.
Oh, he's a special.
Yeah, he's
a
special.
Oh, okay. Totally. And they all have the same back too, so you can have some kind of deception element there, where you don't know what kind of card you're gonna flip on
the
top.
Yeah, I think the money cards are strictly money, and I guess the ship cards are. I'm gonna have to guess the skulls are combat value, and the color is probably a fleet allegiance. But that's trying to guess what this game is, not what.
No, what it could be. But so we could use that to make any kind of suit game, basically.
Okay.
Or a set collecting or a suit game, or as an engine to drive whatever is going on with these figures on a board.
Mm-hmm.
Good so far.
There's four. If there's four suits and there's four different figures, maybe they're linked in some way.
There is a sort of a home base idea with these green.
Right.
These have color matches.
I didn't even notice that, but I'll guess that's true.
So it could be any kind of. We have a board, so we have a grid, so we have movement and tactics.
Mm-hmm.
It could be as simple as just starting with your home base in the corner, so you know where your home base is.
Okay.
Corner.
Can't do an edge.
Yeah.
Six by six.
Yep.
And then these guys can start in the middle corners.
Hey,
we're starting already.
So maybe the game objective is getting back home, something like that. I don't know.
Seems awfully non-interactive. Don't you think the game objective is killing somebody else's house? That's how.
I mean,
that's how people fight. They kill each other's houses.
That
makes sense. But what if this guy is trying to get home and Mr. Dragon Bro is like, I don't want you to go. You know, I don't know. Why am I giving suggestions?
I don't know, but you are giving suggestions because the new name of the game is Mr. Dragon
Bro.
Mr. Dragon Bro.
Question mark, exclamation point.
That's right.
Okay, so we have a home base idea we're juggling with. These represent the players, I would imagine.
And this is all the required components, right? I mean, I know we have lots of other components.
Yeah, you can use anything you want out of it.
And I think the board from Suro.
Mm-hmm.
Is a 6x6 grid, so I think we should also probably incorporate the tiles from Cyril.
Sure.
Because it's a very good chance that anybody who thought we were going to use the board is going to use the tiles.
Mm-hmm.
Probably, yes.
Yeah, I know Cyril, so I know what those tiles do. I don't know what else they could possibly do, but we can mix them up and find out.
Yeah.
These tiles represent every possible combination of joint intersections in an 8-spot grid. With all the reflections taken out, and it happens to be exactly enough to cover 36 spaces.
Okay.
So, you know, in Suro, it is about connected paths.
Right.
That's life, too.
I hate to rip that off from Sirro, but that's if people move around on a board using connected paths, that makes sense.
Sure.
I don't want to just remake Sirro though.
Right, exactly. Could be. I mean, it could be how you move, but it could also be like you have free movement, but those lock in spaces.
Oh.
So instead of you having to play one of those in order to move, you play one of those so that somebody's movement gets
screwed. I wouldn't do that. Making me think through these and play these is really taxing my brain. And Sirro is all about this.
Right.
What we're making is about a lot of other things, too.
Yeah,
here's what I would recommend. Just put them out. Right? Make the board out of these things, but don't have a choice involved in it. Have a discovery involved in it so that we're discovering connected paths, but we're doing it by starting by putting the board out.
So the board starts out.
Let's do that.
Just face down with these things?
Yeah.
Okay. We'll see how that works.
I wouldn't put them under the castles.
I would put them everywhere.
Okay, fine.
There's 36 of them. How are you gonna feel if there's four missing?
I'm gonna feel great.
I'm gonna feel terrible. There should always be exactly 36 of everything. Do I have all the pirate cards?
I think so. Okay, so we got all our tiles down, and this is gonna become.
Is this gonna be guaranteed to?
Oh, it's going to be a mess.
It's going to be a bit of a mess.
It's 36.
Oh, it's 35 tiles, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay, so put the dragon out there. Maybe. And he's a different color, right?
Mm-hmm.
All right, Paul, you get your wish. Can't put cards in the corners because we don't actually have 36 cards.
Okay.
All right. But we won't know what those are. That'll be
mystery.
The strategy element right there.
A stub is always good for mystery.
That's right. Always use a stub. Game designers, take note.
Always
use a stub.
It keeps the mystery.
Count your stub. Okay, so we have a starting board, and
Slayer, I think that might be too easy. We got to get the cards in there too.
Yeah,
first one off the board wins.
Or to the maybe first.
Wait a minute. No, let's talk about that, Slayer. First, you're randomizing the board, then you're flipping them over at random, and then the first one off the board wins. What did I?
That's called Sirro.
Decide? No, that's not called Sirro.
I know.
That's called flipping a coin and taking 20 minutes to do it.
Yeah, but that can be fun too. Sometimes, maybe. Yeah,
all right, you can make the case for gambling games. I'm usually the one who has to do that. All right, so, I guess when you flipped it, you could decide which way to play it. And then you'd be
rotated.
Guessing about all the other face down tiles next to you. It's like 1% strategy and 99% luck.
Well, it's more than that because you might flip it over and your goal at the moment is to get towards the red castle.
Pathing is not enough.
Right.
Well, let's see what happens when we
maybe
flip over
maybe
tile.
The tiles are never
should those start
locked into one direction. They can just be moved multiple times.
Should they start flipped up?
Yeah, well, the guys are on them.
I guess. Sure. But we have already decided that the guys are starting there, so.
Right.
So what does this give us?
Super World Explorer. Super World Explorer. With Dragon Bro and friends.
Now, what does that even mean? These paths join tiles, but we would have to be on a specific path to actually make sense out of them.
And we have to incorporate.
They don't
cards.
Necessarily. They're, you can also think about this the dark space as being the path, and the light space being the wall.
I was wondering about that.
Okay.
It's going to
inverted Sirro.
Yep, and that makes a lot of dead ends.
Yeah, that was what I was thinking.
But a lot of dead ends is probably okay.
Yeah. Right? The only problem is if this flips up with a circle, I don't know how to get out of the
Then we talk about how to get out of it. Jumping over walls isn't impossible. It's just
that's
a cost,
true.
Right?
That's true.
I mean, if we are in a connected space, that's probably more of a problem because then we wind up fighting.
Maybe that's how you fight.
Okay, Paul, what color are you?
I'll be blue.
Okay, well, take your turn.
All right.
Are you sure you want to do that?
No.
Somebody put the deck face up. Okay.
We need some cards.
Well, I don't know. Do you need cards? What do you do? What do you do, Paul? What do you do? It's your turn. Do your thing.
I draw a card.
Game design.
You draw a card. How many cards did you start with then?
None, apparently.
Okay. That's fair. You drew a card. And
I drew a card.
Now you have that. You have $2.
I have $2.
Okay.
$2. I don't know. Maybe you need a certain amount of money to jump out of a thing, so I'm holding on to this.
No, you need fight to get out of a thing. I think the money is what you're trying to collect.
Okay.
Right?
Okay. You're trying to take the loot home?
If the pirate cards are fight, then
take the loot home is a way to do it, right?
Mm-hmm. Okay.
But let's make a game where you have to take all the loot to somebody else's house. Of course you have to take the loot home. All right,
no,
so...
No, you're delivering it. You're a trader. This is about trading, not fighting.
So, well, it's about fighting, too. No, we have to be able to fight. But you can't reach any of us for a fight, right? We're not... We are not sharing any...
Nobody is sharing
any paths yet. And the card you reveal can't possibly link us up because you're going first.
Right.
Okay.
Just geometrically true, because you can only probably reveal the cards next to you, right?
Right.
I guess you could jump a line to get into a fight with one of us, but that's not currently possible.
Unless this whole space is contiguous.
Yeah, that's all. Yeah, you can. You can jump this line. Okay.
Lets me jump a line?
Do you want to do that?
My own color lets me jump a line.
Oh, do we have four matching colors in here that match the colors
here? Yes.
Well, I don't know that they match. One of them's purple, so I don't know if that's purple.
Well, that's the one that's weird. So we've got a blue, we've got a green, we've got a blue and a green, we've got a purple, and we've got a brown. So green is covered, blue is covered.
Green, blue.
That's gross. Well, okay, purple.
He's purple. Gold, which is kind of, the brown's actually kind of gold.
Yeah, and the purple can be the red. That's
purple,
close
red.
Enough.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, so that means they're associated with us somehow. Okay. We got that going on.
We gotta figure out how that matters. Okay, so maybe you draw more than one card, because that only gives you one thing
what
to
I do
right?
Now. Like, drawing this might give me... Well, maybe I'm trying to get to castles to trade.
You started
this
with three, Paul.
Okay,
don't be a fool.
Okay, fine. Okay, well, let's show them so that we've got some idea. I've got two gold ones.
You got one card that belongs to you, which is better. Okay. You've got cards that belong to other people, which is okay.
Okay.
And you've got some money, but not much.
Right.
And if you wanted to go fight somebody...
Do I play their cards to hit them in the face?
No, you play... Oh, I see. I thought you'd play your own cards because they're good for you, but you're right. Those cards tell you who to hit.
They tell me who to hit. These cards
so
maybe tell me...
That's defense?
Or movement.
But that's
these move me and these.
It's always the same number, top and bottom, right? They always match.
Yeah, okay. Just indexed. Okay, well, sure. I think you're brown. Though. That's the problem. See, you're gonna hit him. Why did you do that? That's mean. Let me give you some cards to defend with.
Okay.
So maybe these are defense. Your color is defense and movement.
I don't know about why are you charging me to move? You're requiring that I have a card to move around.
Oh, okay.
I would just say moving is a thing you do.
Well, okay, so if I use his color to attack him, what do I do with my color?
Well, see, this is why I had it the other way around. I had their all attack cards, and your color is just worth a double.
Oh. Interesting.
Oh, so okay. Okay.
So if combat is both players playing a card, most of the time you're playing a card that's 1 to 4.
Right.
But your special cards are going to be worth 2 to 8.
Okay.
Right? Or they could just be +1.
They could be double, whatever. Yeah, what I'm saying is you've got some cards that are better. If they're +1, the overlap is huge. Mm-hmm.
Right, but if they're double, then they just win. So.
Right. So when do you spend those? And they don't just win. Two is still.
You'll always have more of the other guy's cards than your cards too, if the
right.
Whatever spread is the same on all these colors, right?
Okay, so these are all about fighting.
Mm-hmm.
If these are all about fighting. And this is maybe what I'm trying to get to someplace.
Yeah.
And steal from other people. Maybe that's what fighting is.
Okay.
Yeah, you hit somebody, you steal a card out of their hands.
Sounds like pirates to me.
Good. So, and we both play a card.
Come on, let's fight.
Okay.
Let's fight, Paul.
All right.
I've been saving these, so now I got four cards. I'm green.
Oh, I see.
I'm green. Let's do it.
No, okay.
You going to attack me?
You have to be adjacent to fight.
Forget that.
Forget that.
We're fighting. Okay, we're
fighting.
Fighting.
Okay, okay.
That's right. I'm attacking you.
Oh yeah. Well, this. 8.
Oh, you win.
I draw a card from your hand. You should never attack me.
Okay.
Now you win ties. So, I mean, that was the right thing to do.
That was the right thing.
You did the right thing. Come attack me again.
Okay.
8. I get a card out of your hand.
Get my last
card. All right, come attack me. Oh, I got money.
Those are big swings to take cards out of your hand.
Come attack me again.
I got nothing. I'm done.
Yeah.
Come get me.
Okay, I attack you.
1. I win. I get a card out of your hand.
I
get a card off the deck. I get 2 cards off the deck.
I think
because I attacked you with no cards in my hand.
I think cards off the deck is more balanced than cards out of hand.
Nah.
Because he can't do anything.
But all we have to do is decide how fast he draws cards. Right?
Right.
We just did 3 combats. That's silly. But he's got to do whatever he's got to do to get over and hit me.
Mm-hmm.
He's going to win the ties, and eventually he's going to run me out of my high value cards. Now that attack could be more than just an attack, right? You could be betting the card you play. You could be
So there's like a war
deciding
element.
what the value of the contest is before you attack.
Okay.
Right. And it could also be that attacking, like, you don't get one. The only way to get the card is on attack. So then there's some strategy and like maybe.
Yeah, but then defending doesn't really get you anything. It just saves you from.
It tells you which card to lose, basically.
Yeah.
It allows you to lose a specific card.
That's fine. I mean, so now we've just written every other game. What can we do here that's interesting?
Well, we still have no idea how we're moving, for example.
We'll make it
or
free.
What our goal
make
is.
Make it free.
No, that's fine.
If the goal is to run around, grab money, and get home.
Right.
Then, oh, you know what?
A move cost might just feel bad.
No, exploring is what you do.
Right.
Right? So if I turn over a card, that's how I draw more cards.
Okay.
I'm exploring. I'm clearing the board.
Okay,
right?
Sure.
So I do that, and maybe I can move through. Next generation. Hey, something happened.
Just got a pitch of $10 from Slayer. Thank you so much. Appreciate it.
Never donated before, just wanted to. That's awesome. I love the little dancing fat
Never
fat
donated
Spider-Man.
Before, just wanted to. Hash setter dash crop.
I want to look at what our
getting an
paths
idea of how
actually
the paths
look
are
like
work.
If we use the negative space as the paths.
I think there's going to be a lot of dead air.
Yeah, it is.
It's like all very different.
There's some open space, but you're right, it is mostly dead ends.
Well,
it's
like,
also kind of hard
home,
to read.
He can go home. Like,
who can go home?
He could just go home, because it's all one.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Well, is that connected? No, it's connected here. I see.
Right,
sure.
Right.
He can run all the way home. That's good.
Mm-hmm. He's in a hole. That's in a hole. That's in a hole? It's in a bigger hole. She's got a little lake in her hole.
We should. We can turn the tiles, move the tiles around, though, right?
I'm just going to write that down.
Yeah, you should.
This is one of those great conceits of exploring games is that in some of them you get to decide what the terrain looks like when you discover it.
Mm-hmm.
So that it would be up to, you know, this player to say, well, the way it ought to be oriented is, this makes no difference, but whatever.
And maybe they're never static. Maybe you can change them at any time with a little cost or something like
that.
I don't know if that makes it better or worse.
Well, I don't want to think too hard about the geometry of this game.
Okay.
Right? Like, unless the game is about the geometry, don't make me think about it too much.
Okay.
But I don't think the paths are interesting on the negative space. Obviously, they're interesting on the positive space.
Right.
That's what this game is built around.
Right.
But then it's also very close to zero.
Well, that's because it uses the zero components.
That's true.
Let's use the backs of the cards. That's different. So if we
Which
put
direction
ourselves,
is the bamboo pointing?
If we put ourselves on a random path,
okay,
how many of us are connected?
Well, she's just gonna go around in little circles.
Yeah, I know. So she did. Maybe she did that on purpose to be unconnected.
Nobody's connected.
And then how easily could someone be connected?
So we're trying to figure out how the movement
works
in this game.
Blue could move here. No.
Blue would have to move. Here and jump across.
He can move to here and jump over.
Yep.
So
you can move to where they're crossed. You can take a left essentially.
Right.
Are you guys trying to figure out how movement should be costed or
we're trying to figure out the geometry of the board.
Okay.
And how to in Suro it's all about the geometry, but you're trying to stay away from you're trying to just keep moving.
Mm-hmm.
In here, we're actually trying to interact, which is.
You're trying not. In Suro, you're trying to get thrown off the edge.
Right.
I don't know what it means for me to move onto a path with you, though, because doesn't that just mean your next move can be to attack me?
Unless
you're afraid of it, right?
Yeah. Or unless I attack when I move onto it.
Mm-hmm.
And what's their?
But these paths are so long. I can't imagine that you can't fairly easily get almost anybody.
If they would light up, that would be nice. But yeah, you have to look at the whole board every time you do it, or else sort of memorize where everything is.
Like from here, with unlimited movement, even if I can only jump even if I can only turn left or right once, I can get to either of the characters that are actually not running around in a little circle.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Then maybe unrestrained movement isn't helpful.
I don't know. Depends on what else is going on. Depends on what the purpose of it is.
Right.
The first half hour is gone.
Really?
See where you guys are at.
That was pretty fast. Okay, so
quick.
Yeah, we do have about, I think we have another hour and a half or hour to
we'll
get her
fine.
Done. I'm not seeing.
What are you talking about so far?
So far, we have
the outlines of a combat system, kind of.
Sure.
And we're kind of stuck on stuck on how the board, how we're gonna move around the board, if we're gonna move around the board in this particular way. I don't know if you guys are in love with this idea or not.
No, I think, I mean, we're experimenting with the idea of what, is there anything else you can do with the Suro tiles besides play Suro?
Right.
And
Suro with dragons.
Suro is really simple.
Right.
Yeah. Right? Suro is like, look at the line you're on, does it kill or does it go to an edge?
Mm-hmm.
And this one is, look at the whole board all the time and figure out where the line's connected, which is way too much.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Way too hard, even if that was the whole game. I'm thinking about if we use the face-up tiles at all, using them once and throwing them away or something, because the whole board getting as intricate as it does and having to stay alive for as long as it does.
Oh, that is kind of interesting. If you're, like, whatever you're standing on is fine, but as soon as you, like, and then you place this piece, and so you move to there, and then if nobody's on this, it just gets killed.
Yeah.
Hmm.
And then the next time you draw a piece, you see.
Oh, I see. So you actually want to kill every tile that someone's not on, possibly put it back in the stack,
sure,
and use tiles for navigation.
Right.
To try to move closer to other people or farther away, depending on what
right.
you. And I think you're going to need a mechanism for playing more than one tile on a turn so you can go farther than one space, but that sounds interesting.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, let's do that.
Okay.
So start with a cold deck.
So we'll have a tile deck.
Tile deck.
Okay.
Movement like Suro, but not a static board. That's interesting. I mean, does it even...
You get some cold, you get some chat here.
Well, what ones are the guys to stand
are the, no we don't. Because
someone's saying
the ones
in
there
chat,
are already explored, right?
Someone's suggesting in chat we could draw a hand of loot cards, and whatever it is, burn a card to move. The value determines how many tiles you can move.
Yeah, we're way ahead of those guys. So what I'm saying is, you may not even need to place them, except to sort of put your robot path out there. Like, okay, I've got this, I'm trying to get to here, so... this is the same no matter what I do with it. So I'm not going to play that. I'm going to play this, and that lets me get to here.
Right. Okay.
Right?
Okay.
Like
it's not
that it lets me get to here. It's that
this path
lets me get to here. Now,
gotcha.
If I don't play a card, I can do this. Otherwise, we're stuck on the white squares.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Right. But if I do play a card, I can go farther as long as I go where the card lets me go.
You're stuck on the white squares.
If I play a card to move from one space to another,
yep.
It's always going to take me to one of these four spaces.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
I'm never going to be able to go on the ones that are out of phase.
Oh, okay. I see what you're saying. Yes.
If I can play two cards, then fine, I can get out of phase.
Right.
But anyway, if I'm just moving with cards, I think I should be either taking a step or taking a modified step that gets me farther.
Okay.
And actually, all four orientations of this card are the same right turn. Okay. Okay, well, so that card has one function.
So there's actually, you know, quite a bit of movement if you can just jump two, and the board's not that big.
Right. Well, and we want to be close enough to people to attack them, right?
Mm-hmm.
If the board is uncrossably large, then there's not enough of the mm-hmm. interaction that we're looking for.
There's also a chance that we could just say, I'm moving this way, and now I have two
and let choices. The card send you?
Yeah, but it's got...
You don't have two choices, you have one choice.
Well,
and
one,
if that got played the other way, you wouldn't go anywhere at all.
Right.
These cards aren't as versatile as they look.
Yeah.
Could we also use a card, someone suggested from chat, use a card to mess up your opponent's movement?
I'm just concerned that most of the cards in there let you get to at least two of the three spaces. You
don't? I don't think that's true. Let's take a look.
But depending on how you turn them.
That is only one.
Right.
That only has one orientation. That lets you get where you are, turn right, or go straight through. Do I want to go where I am?
No, you can turn left. You can go
oh,
that
okay,
way.
Right. Turn left, turn right. Okay, so that's three. That's your perfect card. That one is...
The same.
Yes,
turn
any,
right.
any one of the three. This one is...
Any one of the three.
Right.
That's what I was concerned about. Any one of the three.
Well...
Any one of the three.
So these allow you to move pretty much anywhere. It's kind of arbitrary what you're putting down, is what you're saying?
Right. So we either need to control how it lands on the board...
Okay.
Oh, I see. Okay.
I mean, there are certain ones that are a specific pattern that screws you up.
Mm-hmm.
But if you can,
that happened to be the ones we tried first.
Right. Like there could be that there's no through line, or it could be that it's only through lines. But those,
yeah,
like
that one.
Right. Exactly.
Okay.
But those are the only conditions under which something will get screwed up.
Well, I don't know the mix of cards, but
sure. But there are sure a lot of them that have one straight through and one curve, which is all you need.
Could we have? Maybe it's not you're not the only one putting cards down. Maybe you put a card down, your opponent puts a card down, and that's kind of the interaction there.
but you still have super control over where they go.
That's true.
And,
still
you one card at a time you do, yeah.
Right.
Well, I don't mind super control. You're a little worried about super control, but
well, I'm
you're just
concerned
saying that
about
it's redundant because the piece doesn't do what a simple step could do.
No, I'm just concerned because drawing the tile has no function if only seven of the giant pile of tiles are different
right.
than the rest of them.
No, you're right.
So we could either do blind movement, or maybe you're not allowed to turn it any direction, mm-hmm. or maybe you have to play a card to turn it. Like you drop it random, and then you have to play. You can play a card to turn which direction.
Yeah. Okay. Well, why are we moving around anyway?
I think we want to get our gold home.
You could put.
We want to get our gold home.
You could spread items throughout the board that they have to go pick up and bring. I don't know. This could represent something, and you get there, and you have to do a thing to get a thing. I don't know. That's an idea.
It could be. Maybe that's where you draw cards.
Okay. Well, maybe you draw cards every turn, so you have a steady supply. But this. We'll start some kind of trigger, some kind of action, or I don't know.
We have a lot of
little pieces we could do things with.
We do have a lot of little pieces.
Mm-hmm.
Are those the same on the back?
These are the same on the back. They are only on one side.
I mean, that's what I mean. Are they blank?
Thank you for the subscription. There, Abrazite.
We have all kinds of things on the back.
Okay.
DTrip87 suggested in chat that we play the tile, but your opponent chooses the orientation. The issue with that is that most tiles will give you access to most spaces.
Right, your opponent.
That's why he wants the opponent to choose. It's going to be the worst possible outcome.
Right.
Okay.
The opponent, it basically would let the opponent choose for sure which tile you almost always
which
choose
way
for
you
sure
go.
Which tile you go. Which mm-hmm. is then we might as well not have the pieces.
Here you go, Paul. Which way should I go?
No, obviously, like I said, there's like five tiles in there that you don't get the control you want on.
Yeah.
Well, we don't have to use these if these are being.
No, I know, but I think there's something interesting there with.
Well, all right, we've messed with them long enough now, though, right? And I think I pulled them out because the board itself is just a 6x6 grid.
Right.
Or is it?
Or are we on the corners?
Or are the markings on the board significant instead of just a picture of a dragon? Maybe the feathers mean something.
Okay. This is getting really deep. We're thinking a lot about movement. I haven't even gotten to the rest of the game, but that's kind of.
Well, we already worked on combat.
It's a board game.
Oh, that's
right?
Done? Okay.
No,
that's not done.
No.
It's worked on.
Okay.
So, well, if we want to run out, grab gold and get it home.
Mm-hmm.
The games that work like this are the ones where I have a decision whether I want to just keep collecting gold and running it home or whether I want to go attack Paul for the gold that he's got.
Okay. Right.
So I care what gold he's got, which means I think he's probably playing it face up. And I guess you're collecting gold, I think you're collecting it face up.
As soon as you get it.
It means I know how many combat cards are in your hand, I just don't know how good they are.
Okay.
What I would love is if we have a way for me to deduce how good they are by watching you play. So trying to get this simpler, you know, I want to see cards go in, I want to see cards go out, and I want to guess what you have left. I mean, the board is a distraction from us at that point. Unless I wish the cards fit on the board, and you know, and perhaps they do, but like to get these interacting a little better, I think we should think about doing something like that. I mean, they do fit without overlapping a neighboring space. You can put a card like this.
Right.
Right. They are as wide as a space. They're just a little bit too long.
Scissors.
Scissors.
So it's less.
We could cut all the indexes off if we did that. I guess we'd have to cut the bottom off.
If we cut the bottom and the top, we'd be. Or the bottom
index. Not the bottom and the top.
No, I just meant we might be able to shave it.
No, cut it here and then you still have your index at the point. Well.
So you're thinking maybe making it less of a board game, more of a card game with.
I'm thinking of it, but the requirement is that we use the board, so let's think about how to do it.
And the pieces.
Like. Let's think about motivation. What did I ask you the last time I played a game of yours?
What are the players doing?
Yeah, what's it about?
What's the game about?
Right. What is a four-player loot collection game about?
Someone
we have pictures of pirates. It's hard not to think about that.
Chat suggesting we could have trade routes. We could have gold moving from place to place. Something like that. With an ability to intercept that gold. I don't know if that's...
But that doesn't really answer the about question.
Okay.
Why do I care that you have gold and I have gold? I mean, I want to.
The obvious is if gold's just victory points, but that's not terribly interesting, I guess.
It is.
Yeah, but again, I'm not asking how to make something into a game mechanic. That's fairly
simple.
I'm asking you to make me care about what's happening.
Okay.
That's
a harder question.
Right.
This giant bird is going to attack.
This giant bird
is going to attack and destroy
unless we cover it with gold.
It's intelligent and it likes to go and it likes to shop, so we could pay it off.
So it's a co-op game then. This is Pirate Pandemic.
Oh, we could if we all cooperatively.
That's all right. Your talking gives me time to think.
No, I know. maybe we are trying to let's talk about co-op. Let's talk about it as a co-op game.
Okay.
It's a giant bird, and it's going to attack.
Called the Sorrow Bird.
It's the Sorrow Bird, and we are trying. So we are trying to get each other the right color of those cards to aid in the attack against it. So to attack and kill the bird.
Okay, so now we're gathering resources to kill some end boss.
Right. To the end goal is to deal enough damage to the bird.
Okay.
But you can only
according to the chat is to give it enough tribute.
Well, if we go the gold route.
Right.
Competitively we
gold is not what birds want. We all know this. They want food. So we want to give the bird tribute. It's going to be food.
Well, the gold on there.
Those
are
that's
giant
not
crackers.
Gold. Those are crackers.
They're gold. Chocolate coins.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they're giant crackers that Polly wants. Polly wants those.
All right,
crackers.
So this is worth 6 chocolate coins.
That is
okay.
Yes,
chocolate coins are a metaphor, obviously, but anyway, sure.
Crazy.
So, all right.
Or
you know more about co-op than I do.
Well, the
if you've ever played one, you know more than I do.
More than once, anyways. So if there's like
the,
a simple
the bird needs an AI. The bird needs an engine.
Right.
Chat can be the engine for that bird. If it's simple enough to give them, you know, binary choices.
The what?
The chat. We can say go this way, go that way, and they'll vote on it. Something like that. Or make these two choices. I'm serious.
Stand down, sir.
I'm serious.
How do we put that in a box?
Oh, it doesn't have to go in a box. We're not gonna sell this game.
Okay.
Yeah.
That could be interesting. So if it's a game about us giving each other the right colors of cards.
Okay.
So we might want to strip out the wrong color, but that's.
What do you mean?
Well, we've got 4 colors and 3 people.
No, you've done this before, and I think it's not worth it.
that is true.
The bird needs an engine.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Like the only co-op game I played recently was Grizzled, and so that's what I'm basing my knowledge of these games on. But like, the board has to fight back.
Right.
It can't just be an accumulator of damage. It has to do something that threatens us that we're going
to
die.
Okay.
Right. We have to be able to lose. The game has to have a system that causes us to lose.
Right.
We could have these dice as like a countdown turn timer or something like that, and every X turns something happens. The bird does something to the board.
You're just forestalling the actual answer, right? What does it do? Right. Paul?
Damage to players, I'm confused.
It could drop D's onto the board.
Bird eggs!
We could drop, bird eggs on the board that crush anything they land on.
Okay, well, I know how to do that.
2d6.
Yep. I like that. Are they crushing resources, too? Like, are we populating the board to start with? We can just use those tiles for markers, honestly, if we wanted to, right?
Mm-hmm.
To say these are things we can go collect until the bird kills them.
True. That's true. That could just, like, whatever's in that space gets
actually won. I think we're adding a step, though. I think the bird could be dropping treasures. Like, the things that it drops could be things we need to go pick up.
Okay. And you don't know until you go pick it up. Maybe this has, you know, 2 out of 6 chance of being a hostile thing. And you,
well, it could, except then I'm not sure I want to go pick it up. It could be a handful of cards, though.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Sure. That could be how we draw cards. We don't just draw. We have to go get the card.
Yeah.
But whatever it lands on.
This evil bird is flying. This is a very video game. He's flying around dropping the tools we need to kill it.
That's right. It's exactly like a video game.
Nothing wrong with
that. If it drops it on one of us or on one of the buildings, they get killed.
Oh, buildings.
How do you determine where it drops it?
By rolling those two.
This.
Oh, right. Gotcha.
1d6.
Okay. Wild.
I know.
Wild.
Yeah.
Well, I'm trying to think of what the lose condition is. Our buildings get destroyed.
Yeah, we lose all 4 buildings.
Like battleship.
That's going to take a very long time.
Well, it could also be that we get destroyed.
We could knock out a couple buildings.
Like, if we're running around the board too, trying to get these pieces, but then it's kind of random as to whether we lose or not.
No, hold on a second. Odds of rolling any corner are what?
36.
No, any corner, not one corner.
Oh, I see. 4 in 36.
So
right?
one in nine.
So
if a castle is eliminated, if it's gone already, but we roll that corner, then it kills the next castle clockwise. So we can continue having them diminish on a 1 and 9. It's still an infinitely long game, but like we could see how much tension that actually has. We have to time it out with the deck too, but but that's another way it can win is just by dropping dropping eggs on the four castles. And I think those castles probably, I mean, we're gonna if we're cooperating, we probably want a little bit of character development. We want the castles to do stuff for us and like be our, you know, this is the green castle, so the green guy gets his power from it or whatever.
Okay. Or in order to give the green guy green cards, we have to go to his castle and then we can dump all whatever green cards.
Oh, I see.
Okay.
Yeah?
And then he now has a big hand of green cards.
Okay. How are we moving then? Are we spending gold to move? That's not gold yet, but that's a resource that seems to be in the kind of abundance that we need to actually get around this place. Mm-hmm.
Maybe that accelerates us. Maybe we get to move one pawn, one space every turn, and we spend gold to go
farther. Yeah. Okay. Because otherwise the board's getting a little big, but that's fine. Right. All right, let's try that. So the game begins. We have cards in our hands. We think we're trying to win. And Paul, what do you do? I shouldn't make you go first. I should go first. You went first last time.
I know.
All right, well, let's see.
Well, I am the oldest.
We've also discarded the idea of these being used for movement, right? These
at the moment.
Yeah,
the moment,
I don't think that they have they don't have the
we're just working with this board
versatility that I wish they had. Like,
unless we make
a
it
component
very
like that promises some degree of utility, and that doesn't yet do anything near what it's costing us in cognitive load. So, for now.
The only reason it really works in Sorrow is because it makes the board smaller every time you put one on there.
Well, that and you only have to check it once. And then you know, played cards are basically blank. Do we drop an egg every turn?
I think that's the only way the game has a chance of ending very quickly in this particular setup.
That's true, because it's 1 in 9 to kill a quarter.
Right.
Okay. So this is my origin, and I think the base is orange, so that's 2 by 5. Puts a thing here. And did we decide? Am I green?
Sure.
So I can take one step.
And then you can play gold to take more steps.
I'm gonna say a column of gold is a step.
Sure.
So this is worth 2 for me.
Sure.
Right.
Yeah, seems fine.
Never mind. Because then they're all
a row.
They're
of
all them. 2. So a row. A row.
Yeah. Because this one.
A full row or a half row. So is this 2 or 3? This is a 2.
I'm confused. What is going on?
We're reducing the numbers from 1 to 8 down to a more reasonable set of numbers.
And so is this. So I mean,
these are both 2s.
Okay.
So yeah, that means that the one coin is a blank, if you do it that way.
Yeah.
I think this has to be a 3.
Yeah, rounding up.
Okay. That way. So the way you read this number, this is a 3.
Okay.
We're just transforming this because we don't have the right deck.
Okay.
But this is a move 3, which is plenty enough for me to get here and do whatever I do when I go to an egg, which is.
Okay.
Get some more cards.
I get some more cards.
That's how you get cards.
I get this many cards.
Okay.
Sure. Don't waste the dice, right? Okay, so I got some cards. Now, how do I fight the bird?
With your color of cards? You can only use your color of cards. Maybe you have to go to your base and then dump out cards.
Oh, no, I fight the bird whenever he drops an egg on me. Because I have to wait a long time to do that.
Maybe
the bird is.
I think you go to your own castle and then you dump out your cards and that fights the bird.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
Maybe the castle has a stable.
Oh, right, because we're giving it tribute, right? We were going to give it coins in tribute, but we could give it fight in tribute instead.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But they're my cards. And if I get your cards, I.
You have to give them to me. So you have to go to my castle.
I can leave them on the board.
It's probably.
I could go to where you are.
That's fine,
I'm
too. I was just trying to think
lost
of.
Right now.
We'll catch you.
Okay. I was just thinking that having to go to the other players' castles.
A long walk.
It is, but that's.
I'd rather walk to you.
Okay, which might be just as far, depending on where I am.
It is almost never going to be as far. But anyway, sure. So I picked up some cards, and I'm going to call that done.
All right.
Okay.
So roll us a bird dropping, Paul.
4 by 4.
Okay.
4 by 4. There we go. It lands on me.
So that's gotta be bad for you, right?
That seems bad. I can either. I mean, maybe it doesn't kill the characters; it just kills the castles.
I think you go home and drop your cards.
Oh, it sends you home?
Oh, a new guy comes out.
Yeah.
So I drop my cards there.
Drop your cards there and go home.
But and the egg shattered because there's no more resources. Mm. I drop my cards. Yeah, okay. That's good.
That's okay. A pretty steep penalty for getting your egg.
Whatever, you went home. That's good. Home isn't really that far away.
There's only a 1 in 12 chance that a character gets sent home on any particular turn.
That's not, I don't know why this guy's not in.
There's only three of us.
Yeah, but that doesn't mean this guy can't AI, right?
Okay, throw him in there. Yeah, sure.
Sure. Oh, so that there's always four turns.
Four targets.
Four
egg targets.
Does he take a turn too, or does he just hang
I don't know. We haven't got to his turn yet. All right. What's wrong with you, Paul?
I'm sorry. I'm just screwing it up.
We got an egg.
Okay, so... Two and three.
Two, three.
Yeah. Okay.
And what color are you?
I'm not sure.
You must be red, right?
I'll take red.
Okay.
Okay, so then I, draw...
You got to go there.
No, you got to move a space.
How am I moving?
You move one space for free.
That's a move three.
Okay, so I have a move
and you have,
three.
You have one free move too?
You have to, because the chance of...
Okay, so that'll get you all the way to the egg, or it'll get you to... One, without playing the card, you can walk to that.
That's more interesting. Yeah,
I'll just take your free step and grab those things.
Okay.
I mean, we're not balancing this game yet, are we? We're just playing it.
No, we're just trying to figure out how it works.
He's got to take a turn, right? The AI takes a turn, which is a pure egg drop. And what?
That's good. I was wondering, it seemed likely that if we don't get hit, that every turn we just, go grab an egg, go grab an egg, go grab
an egg. I think the board's going to litter up a little bit.
Yeah, yeah.
Like we play all of our money out, and then we're going to have trouble moving.
Okay.
Yeah, that's
probably true. Boom! One castle out.
Green no longer has a castle.
Green no longer has a castle, whatever that means.
Does it not... But don't we need the
castle?
Let's
worry about balancing later. We're trying to get the mechanics.
Okay, right? Okay.
All right, so that happened. No egg, castle dead.
But it is your turn.
That's my turn, so I'm very sad about my castle dying, but I will play this move too, which is more than I need to go grab this egg, because it is full of five cards.
Uh-huh.
And I want to fight the bird, which means I need to go to somebody else's castle and turn in some cards, right?
Sure.
Except, green cards are no good anymore, right? Because that's, I would,
unless,
anybody turns in green cards here to fight the bird.
Is that true, or is that anybody turns in, maybe?
It has to be their own cards, doesn't it? Your own cards at any castle, because the players stay alive and the castle's done.
Right.
Okay, so I'm going to go turn in green cards at
maybe
a castle.
Maybe there's a bonus if you're in your own castle playing cards or something.
Right, and that's the bonus that you lose when it dies.
Okay.
Right. Okay, it's your turn, Paul. Shall I roll the egg drop for you?
Please.
Your castle was almost crushed by an egg.
Oh, but luckily it was not. I have no cards, so I guess I move one.
Oh, that sucks. Boom. I wish I could help you somehow.
Oh, well.
Someday.
Hmm.
Someday. You need some cards, man.
One and five.
That bird really hates that castle.
And I'm the red guy. Okay, so let's say I'll move...
Total three,
can I use two cards?
Yeah, sure. You've got you got five moves plus
six?
A free one.
I don't think you need all those. You get one for free.
Oh, okay. Well, then I'll just do one, two, three, move there.
Right. Of course. So spend your three and your.
And then I'll roll my dice for
six cards.
That's kind of a lot.
What a payoff.
Okay. So then I draw six cards and I'm done.
Then I think so. Yeah.
Okay.
So and the action that you take at a castle, I'm rolling for ghost. One and two. Oh, there's already an egg there.
Nothing happens.
Poof! They crush each other.
All right.
Damn bird. What the hell's wrong with you? Crushing your own eggs. How are we supposed to beat you? And now it's my turn, and it's six and six.
Oh!
And that's the blue castle dead. I'm going to... what am I going to do? I don't have a lot of move here.
So I'm saying...
But I've got her.
You've got her. She must do something good.
She's got to do something good. I'll figure that out in a second. What do I actually want to accomplish? I want to fight the bird, which means I want to go to a castle and turn in this damn card.
You have a green on the end too, or is that a...
No, how do I give cards to you?
You come to me.
Man, that's a long ways off. I have one move.
The whole losing all your cards thing is pretty brutal.
Yeah, that's true. You got hit by an egg. Is that what you're thinking?
He's out of the game for three turns.
A long time. Yeah, yeah. Well, that only if we can't help him, right? If we could just throw him stuff without having to go to him.
Okay.
So I could give him a hand of cards if I wanted to, but damn.
It seems like there's more of these than move cards also.
Well, right. That's important.
Right.
We want that to be the game.
Oh,
well,
you do?
Do we? I mean, when I go and turn in cards to fight the dragon, it really doesn't matter how many I turn in.
Maybe you can only turn in one color of card at a time.
Well, I thought I could only turn in mine. Oh, I'm. I, I can only turn
in mine. Oh, you can only turn in yours. That's right.
Right? So these are all useless to me until I give them to you.
Right.
How do I give them to you?
By us being on the same spot.
How do I get there?
By moving.
That's tough.
He's gonna spend four turns moving to you.
That's tough.
What you guys got so far?
We got an hour's worth of development and a 2-hour process.
Hey, it works.
Yeah.
What's it looking like so far? What are your base mechanics you've come up with?
Well, so we are cooperating to fend off the attacks of this bird.
Okay.
This giant bird that's come to destroy our kingdom.
God, these fucking giant birds. God damn it.
They're everywhere.
They do that. And so every turn the bird, and I want to reset the game and talk about some rules, but every turn the bird drops an egg in a random spot.
Okay.
And it turns out that this was one of our castles.
Okay.
And that got crushed.
By the bird.
But because the game dies really quickly right now, if one castle is already gone, then it just crushes the next one.
Right.
So this is the timer. If this is gone, we're all dead.
Okay.
And we're trying to throw hurt at the bird. I think I should not have to go anywhere to throw hurt at the bird. Right?
Okay.
Because if I can stand right here and do this, at least that's helping a little.
Yeah, that's true.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
That's true.
So the bird's got to accumulate a certain amount of damage.
Right.
And a lot more than that, because that's the first time we've heard it.
Right.
And I guess we're working together?
We just got to fend it off.
Maybe there's a matrix of getting all the colors against him.
How is this going to happen?
Well, maybe we're actually going to take AI turns.
Yeah, okay. This guy's playing by himself because we have four players in a 3-player game.
I think a lot of times, they're very interested in what you guys are coming up with. Would it work? I think Fixmaster was asking what if a player controlled the bird, too? That'd be interesting as another thing, too.
One of the players controls the bird? Yeah, you can do it.
Like a 1v3.
That's possible. As soon as we need the bird to do anything intelligent.
Right. Rather than drop eggs on shit.
Yeah, I mean, currently we're building sort of your standard co-op game where that you were playing against an AI.
Very cool.
If we wanted to build a Dungeon Master scenario, then the bird would have to have choices, and that's adding even more. I'm not sure we want to go that far right now.
Mm-hmm. You guys are good at this. Should think about doing this for a living.
I wish I did. I really wish I did. All right, so...
I do this for 2 livings.
I want to... Yeah, shut up. I mean, I do this for 0 livings. So,
wow.
So.
All right.
All right. Are
we in love with what we have so far?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
You're not, but we see how we're gonna
fix
it.
I'm just,
We see how we're gonna fix
it. This is the thing we've done many times. Like, this was the problem I had being on, Tabletop Deathmatch, was that Mike called me on a million times, where it's like, we'd look at the game and everybody else would be like, well, and I'd be like, this game is amazing. And he's like, Paul, you see what that game looks like after you fixed it.
Right.
That's not what this is about at all.
Okay.
Like, yeah,
well,
yeah, okay.
Because you were reviewing submissions, right?
Right.
You weren't working on games.
Right.
You were reviewing other people's games. And I've been in that meeting with you, too.
Yeah,
where
you
look at somebody's game, and you're like, I see how this could be good. And I'm like, I know, right, but his job was to make it good before he brought it to him.
Yeah.
So exactly. In playtesting, that's in inventing.
Right.
That's perfect. You see where it's going to go.
Yeah, yeah. Okay.
In reviewing somebody else's game, it's not helping because I don't want to take someone's project and then do an entire round of game design to make it good.
Sure.
All right, but we still have an entire round of game design to make this good.
Yeah, at least one.
All right, reset your castles, gentlemen, because this bird is impossible to beat. So I want to be able to, I want an action where I throw you as many cards as I want.
From anywhere?
From anywhere. Here's your cards, right? Because at the end of my turn,
instead
I want to do something useful, right? I can move and grab stuff.
Okay.
I can throw stuff at the bird, which is my color. I can throw stuff at you, which is your color.
Okay.
Right?
Or anything. Maybe you could throw me a move card.
Throw you whatever you want, right? If you need move cards, I throw you that.
Maybe
communication that we have, I can't show you what's in my hand, but you can certainly, I can see what you need. You need move cards right now. Okay, so let's try that.
Maybe you can throw me one card, but if we end up in the same spot, we can just like look at our hands and trade them back and forth.
Oh, in the same spot. Trading in the same spot. I like that. Okay. And I was going to have there's 8 of these Suro pieces, right?
Yes.
I was going to have that be the upper limit of eggs on the board at a time.
Okay.
Just because it seems like a good mechanic and there has to be some sort of piece limit, and that's what we have.
Totally.
So let's do that.
Okay.
All right. So this is, the bottom is orange. This is the origin. I'll go first, and the first egg drops.
Oh, I cast
here.
All 5.
1/5. Mm-hmm. All right, so that's our first egg, and because we're playing open-handed to learn this game, I'm going to show you what I've got. I've got hit cards for.
Let's see what card for me.
Oh, my special.
Okay. You're purple, right?
Let's do this.
What's going on? Did I give you too many cards?
I just allocated.
I've got hit cards for you.
Okay.
I've got hit cards for Lazenby here, which I don't know what I'm supposed to do with them.
I don't know.
Maybe we can all play them.
Yeah, maybe.
That's
maybe
fine,
we give
right?
him a hand, and when it gets to five,
well, I think non-players, I should just be able to play his cards. Why not?
As far as figuring out the mechanic, right?
let's just let me do that. Yeah.
And I got a couple of move cards.
When there's actually four players.
So can I get to the egg? 1, 2, 3, 4. No, I can. I can barely get to the egg. Do I want more cards? I do like losing all your cards, by the way.
Yeah.
You said it was hurtful, but it's true. But it's a risk to carry a bunch of cards.
Mm-hmm. And as long as we have a mechanic where you guys can be like, oh, you're screwed here.
Right. As long as we can feed each other cards, I think it's okay.
Or this will let you get back to your card.
So do I want a bigger handful of cards, or do I just want to throw some hurt at the bird? I can't do that, right? I have no cards for myself.
Green cards, yep.
All right, so I'm gonna spend all my move and go grab this egg.
Okay.
And then this is the worst part, by the way.
This is the worst
part. A random number of cards is gotta go, but for now I'll get six cards.
It could just be three. Just like done. Three cards.
Three cards.
Yeah, three cards.
But every egg is different.
Okay.
You know giant bird eggs.
Yeah, that's
true. I'll take three cards. I'll take three cards and like it. Don't waste dice. I'm not showing you what I have now.
Okay.
Okay, and you're
done. That's not good.
So you can't give me a card because you chose to do a move action.
Yeah, I moved and grabbed an egg, and that's that. Right? If I'm like impotently not moving, then I can hand cards to somebody else. Paul, this is your egg drop. Oh dear. My castle's dead.
No, it's not. It's 1-3, not 1-1.
You're right. It's 1-3. What if my castle was there?
Then it would be dead.
I'm so sure.
Okay, all right.
I think it's getting late.
We're an hour in, and we're getting punchy already. I think. So there's the thing now about like, do I punch it now or do I wait till I have more? I mean, I might as well collect more cards and then throw it.
The odds of you getting hit are really low.
They're only one in 36.
Right. So you don't want to waste a whole turn just hitting it for 4 points.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Can you throw more than one attack card or only one?
Yeah, you drop the whole bit. That's why you want to be able to save up a bunch.
Okay. Right.
Okay.
So I think.
Otherwise, it would be an autoplay for him to play the card he's got. Mm-hmm. He's always got to have the choice to accumulate more power or spend what he's got, with the risk being that he can get hit.
So what are the castles for now? Are they just Is there any reason for us to go to the castles? Not at the moment.
I know how to raise the risk of you getting hit. Well, the castle could always be three free cards, right? I know how to. Besides, I think the castle is a punishment. You go to the castle when you get killed.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And I want to raise the risk of you getting hit by instead of crushing an egg with another egg, by incrementing by going to a neighboring spot.
If I
roll this again, then by some procedure, probably like, you know, by reading left to right, so it goes here, the egg drops here. And that means the more eggs are on the board, the more likely it is that someone's gonna get hit, because the eggs only land in empty spaces.
Right. Right? Well, that could definitely be true. It could also, if the procedure is that it moves towards the nearest object, castles before it dies.
It just finds an object.
No. That would be ouch. No, but if it hits here, then it chooses by saying, oh, there's objects within two, and it cares about castles more, so it gets placed here.
I get it.
And maybe even it's
strange. The logic I was using was, start like you read a book, start in this corner, go that way. Right?
Oh, I see.
Right? And if you can't go that way, go down. But I mean, basically it's just incrementing that way. So like downwind is the worst place to stand.
Okay.
You don't want to stand downwind to the egg.
Sure.
But if there's an egg here and I roll this space, it's going to hit way over here.
Oh, I see. Typewriter.
Yeah. Just typewriter rules. And so this leads back to this.
Yeah.
Although in this case, it doesn't have to because we just kill a castle.
Right.
Okay. So what are you doing on your turn?
I can't reach an egg. I could either give one of these to, I could give you one because you obviously didn't have an attack.
Yes, I accept.
Do I get my free move too? I don't know why I would move.
No, you don't move.
I don't know why I would move. Okay.
So giving cards uses up your move.
Your action. Yeah.
Okay.
The thing you do.
That was my turn.
It isn't even a set of phases. It's I roll for the egg and then you do one thing.
Yep.
Yeah. Okay. I roll for the egg. 5-5 is here. Egg dropped.
Okay. I think I can get that on the red dude. So boop boop boop.
Yep.
Pick that up. Roll another die. Two. Draw two.
Oh, you're drawing three. It's always three.
Three. Oh, it's always three.
It's always three.
Yeah, we went to a straight three for that.
That's how much.
Because I mean, how cruel do we need this giant bird to be?
Right.
Yeah, exactly.
Should be 3.5 though.
Sure.
All right.
Did you draw three last time? You get four this time.
Right. Try to remember. This is the egg drop for Lazenby. Lazenby is the name of the character who is not here. That was a little dangerous. and that's all he does, right?
Yep.
He has no hand, he does nothing, he's responsible for 1 in 4 PA drops.
Exactly.
how do we figure, oh, we can all play his cards.
Right. As ours or in
as our own. But just they're just wilds for us, right?
Okay.
Okay. So my turn. I think on 4-5.
So right now we're chasing down eggs, getting more cards. Do we? I'm just trying to think of.
I hear what you're thinking.
What else?
But I disagree. I have no movement cards.
Eric.
Ouch.
Yes.
You have had far too easy of a time.
No, we haven't.
I need. So we've gotta spruce it up a little. If anyone donates,
ding,
$25.
Okay.
Who's blue? Are you blue, Paul?
$25. Yep. That
can
is
you give me
it.
Two cards or
give
just
you,
one?
I can give you as many cards as I want, but I'm giving you those.
Okay. We will force them to incorporate Cards Against Humanity into this game.
What are they? What do you need?
$25.
$25 from one person or from lots of people?
Okay.
See, I mean, somebody might have already sent in the $25 time I finished that sentence. This it has happened before. Collective is fine.
Collective
Joe.
Is fine. All right. So 25 people give $1. Then this game, which is coming along just fine, thank you very much. It's a long way from done, but at least we have something.
I'm just doing my job.
Now we have to incorporate Cards Against Humanity.
No, we don't. They haven't donated it.
So
quick, let's finish this before we have to incorporate Cards Against Humanity.
Yeah.
All right. Good luck. Just, you can just kind of creep that into frame gently. Yeah. All right. That was my turn. I gave Paul some cards.
Okay. So roll an egg.
Roll that beautiful egg drop.
1-5. That's you.
By the way, this is a
that's
terrible.
You.
Oh, that's me. Okay, so
thanks for giving me all those.
I'm
cards.
Glad I gave you those cards because now I think we decided these cards stay here mm-hmm. and I go home.
Mm-hmm. Welcome to home. All right. So, but it is my turn.
I'm still unclear on what the next kind of phase of the game would
be. Well, on my turn, I have a lot of these.
Okay.
I could play them.
Okay.
But I think I'm gonna wait one more.
Oh, the egg dropped on me.
The egg is right next to
you. You're greedy?
Wow.
I know.
Okay, 25. Really fast. Okay, so. We'll see how we can. It's always Cards Against Humanity.
It's right, always
so,
Cards
well,
Against Humanity.
Well, that is easy. Cards Against
it's
Humanity.
It's too bad there aren't any other games just like
hashtag
Cards Against
Ren
Humanity.
Rocket.
We can mix it up a little bit.
Thank you, Wisp, for making this more difficult. Let's see how this goes. Okay, so we have Cards Against Humanity. Maybe that could come out of these eggs. Every egg pick up.
But we just have to use the cards in some way, right?
Right.
Did they mention which components we have to use? Maybe we only have to use the box.
Oh, that's true.
I mean, I don't even know how you use the box. I think they want us to use the cards for sure.
It's not always Cards Against Humanity.
It's not always.
It used to be Giant Jenga.
It was Giant Jenga. It was Giant Jenga.
But Giant Jenga was painfully boring.
It was kind of messy.
That's because it wasn't written with the cards from Cards Against Humanity.
And there are many games similar to Cards Against Humanity.
True.
In fact, this is probably the last
that
week
was,
that we'll use
that
Cards
was,
Against Humanity.
Okay.
That was a little joke.
What are you thinking?
I don't know. Let's look at what we could do. All right.
What were the worst things about the game we just played? What were the biggest open questions about the mechanics so far? Well, I mean, your question was, how do we end this thing?
Right.
Which
where
just
going?
Means you weren't enjoying it. The other one is, like, the game timer is ludicrously random.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
like, the real game timer is probably this deck.
Right.
Because the all four castles get destroyed could happen in 4 turns or infinity turns.
Right.
And without really an average in the middle.
Mm-hmm.
So that's a problem. Another problem is too much free movement of cards, not enough decisions, not enough things to do.
Right. And we also don't know what the AI for the extra guy does.
Well, we'll have other more players in the final, run through, so
sure.
that can be an actual person.
What do you do with Cards Against Humanity cards that isn't Cards Against Humanity?
You play either black ones or white ones.
Yeah. they're just black and white cards.
Black and white cards.
No, I think we can do better than that. So what I was thinking was that there's an extra penalty. You have to, at the beginning of your turn, instead of rolling for the bird, you have to draw one black and one white card and read them out loud without laughing.
Oh.
Okay. And if you can do that, then good for the game. And if you laugh or in a stutter or anything, then bad for the game. Whatever those results are.
Okay.
Right? It's one egg or two. Right?
One egg or two.
Right? And if you can't even get it out, then it's three eggs. Like, if you can't even read the cards at all, it's three eggs. Like, is that... Let's just try it. Okay. Paul, I want you to read the top two cards without laughing.
I'm gonna have to do it here.
Okay.
I am become famine, the destroyer of growing a pair.
That wasn't too hard. It probably isn't gonna be too hard either, especially since we've seen all these cards before.
Let's try this again. Ooh, goddamn, I love the unstoppable tide of Islam. I'm good at doing these things without laughing.
I actually laugh very, very rarely when I play Cards Against Humanity.
All right.
So I am amused many times, but laughing.
Yeah.
So what's another mechanic? Since it's hard to make us laugh.
Since we're cold bastards. We're all dead inside.
Yeah.
The last time we used it, we just used the word count as a value.
Oh, that's depressing.
Just super basic.
That's depressing.
I mean, that was the best we could come up with. It doesn't have to be,
I've done some
integral
like this.
Part of the mechanic.
Oh yes, it does. Somebody gave us $25.
Okay,
are you crazy?
Okay. Well, we got to use.
We get half of that, right? Wasn't that the deal?
We'll see.
You told us we each get half.
Beers.
So you should be happy that there's
we
not.
We can
more
talk
than
about
two
that after the show.
Let's see.
Oh, concentration.
Trying to.
So I every time I put a card on the board, I read it out loud, and later it's going to be important for us to remember which ones are where. Right? Or remembering a line of them, or remembering a whole series of them, or whatever.
Like, okay, we put them on the board.
So I read this and I say, this is Stephen Hawking talking dirty.
Mm-hmm.
And then at some point, it's necessary for someone else to remember that, or me.
In order to...
I don't know, accomplish something.
If an egg lands on one of those spaces...
We have to remember what it was.
You have to remember what it was, or... and it's your turn. You have to remember what it is, because you roll on turns.
Right.
And if you don't remember what it is, then instead it takes out a castle.
Oh, ouch.
Hmm.
Yeah, that's nice. That'll accelerate the end game because these are going out one at a time,
right?
Mm-hmm. Right? We don't populate the board to start with. Mm-hmm. Every turn we draw one, we read it, we enjoy it, whatever, we put it down. Mm-hmm. Okay, this card is here now. This is something about Stephen Hawking, right? And like, I don't remember the exact wording already.
Oh, that's bad.
So I don't think I can save us from that. Oh, I like that a lot. Remembering the wording on Cards Against Humanity cards is actually kind of a good challenge.
Especially the white ones. The white ones are the best cards to do.
Okay,
nice.
So...
All right, we're using the white cards.
What is the interaction again with the card? So,
put at the beginning
down.
Of every turn,
mm-hmm.
the bird gives us a phrase that we have to remember. Mm-hmm. That phrase is dead parents.
Okay.
This movie has been rated B for Batman. Maybe may not be suitable for children with small families.
Okay.
So I say dead parents. Everyone mm-hmm. sees that it says dead parents. Right, we burn that into our brain, okay. And then I pick where it goes. And
pick where it goes, or does it go where the egg goes?
No, I pick where it goes. Because I place it before the egg drops.
Mm-hmm.
This is an empty space. I have to place it in an empty space.
Sure.
Maybe it has to...
We could change it if pacing's bad.
I'm telling you my version.
Okay.
I'm going to get all the way to the end, I promise. Then...
Not today.
Then I roll for the egg, right? If I roll 2, 3, it's my turn. I have to remember dead parents. And if I don't remember dead parents...
Yep.
Somebody loses a house.
Yep.
Okay.
I love it. We gotta do that.
Yeah, yeah.
We gotta do that.
But that's only if the egg lands on that
only
card.
Only if the egg lands on it. But we're adding a new egg to the board every turn.
Gotcha.
And by the time there's four of them, we're fucked.
Mm-hmm.
Every time an egg hits
right.
a card,
okay.
yeah.
We're like, oh god, was that dead parents or was that Stephen Hawking?
Okay.
I don't remember, right? And I think Stephen Hawking, by the way, is enough. Like, I don't think we have to remember the exact wording of it.
Right.
I think if we remember this with Stephen Hawking,
remember
we're,
the pronoun.
We're doing great.
Sure.
Right? Right.
The end of it.
Right?
That's ejaculating the...
I mean, I think maybe if we need a rule, it would be get at least two words right. So dead parents is dead parents. But
yeah.
Stephen Hawking is enough for that one.
Sure. Sure.
Or maybe we make it harder. It will depend on how hard it is in reality.
Do you have ideas for how you want to defeat the bird?
Yeah, we're throwing hit points
it's
at
just,
it.
Yeah,
I don't mind throwing hit points
at we'll figure
yeah,
out 50, whatever the point
yeah,
is.
Yeah, yeah. For now, let's throw hit points at it. Like,
okay.
That combat and that sort of thing have been done so many times, they're not hard to do.
Okay.
We're trying to figure out the rest of the engine.
Okay.
Let's pump it up.
All right.
Okay.
Plus, I mean, we still have two safety valves. We have more than two safety valves. We got these crazy guys.
Yeah.
Oh, I bet it's one personality for each color. I bet that's who was in there.
Mm.
Right? Right? We got yellow... Yeah, we got all. There's four pizzas.
So they're jokers, kind of. Okay.
I don't know what they are, but that's how many are in there.
Yeah.
Wait, he doesn't have a border. Now I'm confused.
Maybe he's wild for
yeah,
those guys.
Oh, yep. He's wild for those guys, right? Because
okay.
He doesn't have a color.
Or something.
You can just take those out?
No!
You think of things for those? Okay.
Why would we take those out?
I don't know.
Those are vital components that we were assigned to use.
Yeah, besides, you know, Paul will tell you this. Specials make every game better.
Richard Garfield's School of Game Design.
No, what they really do is they get us out of jams if we have other problems with this mechanic. We have to play it a few times to figure out what the problems are.
Sure.
And then like we did with the Cards Against Humanity cards, like, let's solve a problem with this. Let's not just incorporate it. Yep. Let's knock down a wall.
Okay.
Right. We've got all sorts of stuff we haven't used yet. Like,
I like these starting spaces. That's pretty good.
Yeah, I was thinking that we don't want to be right next to each other, so we can't just jump on each other and trade all our cards.
Not only that, but we are now like better able to reach all the drops.
Right, right. Somebody can, no matter where it lands.
Somebody's two steps away from a drop.
At most, yeah.
All right, so I'm starting us with four again. I would write down the rules, but we have video of this, so.
That's right. They know the rules.
Paul, you can go first this time.
All right, I love going first. This is a pretty
drop amazing. An egg.
Drop an
Wait!
Egg.
Before you drop an egg, incorporate the Cards Against Humanity mechanic.
Okay. Pac-Man uncontrollably guzzling cum.
All right, good.
Okay.
Okay, and it's gonna be right where you were standing.
Sure.
Terrible.
Now I just have to form a mental image.
Pac-Man uncontrollably guzzling cum.
I'm not, if I have
I
to remember
I wish I could
thing,
unthink that mental image, but okay, we got it.
No, this is worse than Cards Against Humanity because you have to keep multiple images fixed in your head for the whole game.
Yeah.
That may never be important, and yet it always is.
All right. This is beautiful.
All right, we have an egg.
This is beautiful.
I wish that had landed on you so I could get that card off the board.
Is that when, if we get it correctly when the egg lands on it?
Yeah, it's safe. Okay. It's safe, right?
Okay. We only have to remember it
correctly
remember
until
once.
It gets blown up.
Okay. Well, I get three cards because it landed right next to me. I get three cards.
You got the three card egg, all right.
Okay.
Four
three
by
three. And
the
four.
No, you got it backwards. It's four by three.
Okay.
This is the orange
four
axis.
And three. Four and three.
Yep.
And I'm here. I can spend this card to move. Can I go diagonally?
Nope.
No.
Nope.
I can't get that. Then.
You can go share cards with Paul. Like, if you get on him, you can, like, totally swap anything in your hand.
Hmm.
And you are purple?
I don't know if I'd want to do that.
You didn't do a card.
You didn't do a card.
Oh, okay. Got to do a card. Okay.
You have to re-roll the egg. Where did you drop it? Here?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, back up.
Tom Cruise is my card.
Tom Cruise, uncontrollably guzzling Pac-Man. It doesn't have to go there. It can go anywhere. It doesn't have to go where you're standing.
Oh, no?
No. I mean, it's okay if it does. I'm just saying you have to put it in an empty space.
Oh.
So I think.
That's fine.
I guess the space where you're standing counts as an empty space. It doesn't have an egg in it.
So I've got confused already. Three
six
is.
Six and three.
Six and three. Okay, so it's at the bottom. Okay.
Well, you just got robbed of your egg. I apologize.
No, that's fine. You missed a vital step.
He couldn't get to
And I was thinking, does Lazenby have to draw a card too, or does he get a pass?
That is a good question. The pacing of the game, always four players, is interesting.
I think that we should skip him. I think we shouldn't have to remember his
Maybe card. He has to put a card down, but he doesn't have to remember if an egg lands on a card on his turn.
Oh, he's like a free pass?
He is, but he's filling up the board with cards.
I like the free pass because four brains trying to remember something will make it easier than three, so he's like giving us that random free pass. But we still have to look at the card, though, right?
Yeah.
Right, but if it happens on his turn, he doesn't have to. Does the active player have to be the one who remembers?
I think so.
Oh, shit. Then no. Okay, that hurts. Okay, good. Okay.
Well, yeah, the three of us trying to remember, it's going to be a lot easier.
Yeah.
I can't do much from here, though. What do I...
You can hand individual cards, or like blocks of cards, to someone.
Right. Mm-hmm.
If you move to him, you can...
We can do a big swing
do
swap.
A total hand swap, or, you know, put it all in one place, or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
You can throw a card at the bird.
I feel like I should just throw cards at the bird.
Yeah, that's fine.
Sitting here doing nothing.
Let's do that. So save your. Well, you gotta. But you can only play your own color.
Oh.
You can only throw purple cards at the bird. If you want to share cards with Paul, you can give him cards he can play.
Oh. Okay. Interesting. And I can only do one of those things.
So like throwing two damage at the bird is kind of a weak turn.
A weak turn. Sure.
Right.
But you're right. There's no way to accumulate more cards right now. So.
Unless I get another egg. So. And I can throw cards at him remotely?
Yep.
Yeah, you can give you can
what
push
color are
you? He's
blue.
He's blue,
blue.
So yeah,
okay,
give him the blue
eggs. Well, do that.
Okay.
That's okay,
dude. I'll pass.
Let's see. So we're drawing a card for Lazenby. That card is William Shatner. It's going under him because that's just automatic.
Sure.
And maybe it has to go under you, I don't know.
I was thinking that might work.
Mm-hmm. And if you're standing on a card, then you get two cards in the same space, and it becomes more burdensome.
Sure.
Okay. I liked playing it in an empty space, but it's sort of irrelevant.
Mm-hmm. Or maybe if you're
standing.
You are standing
in an empty space by default, so
right.
I think that's
usually.
The same thing. Unless you're standing with somebody. You're not standing on an egg. That's the only other place you can be standing.
Right.
I guess you could be standing in a castle.
Or you could be moving towards something and you back onto it. Like if an egg lands here and I don't have movement, maybe I move here anyways.
Right. Well, I think that's
okay.
Just two cards in that space.
Okay.
Just makes it more volatile. It makes that space harder. What was that? William Shatner?
William Shatner.
Okay, and I'm dropping an egg for Lazenby. And that is here. I can reach that. I will reach that. So I'm playing a move to get these three cards. And that is my turn.
Okay.
All right.
Oh, I didn't do a card. God damn it. Okay, and well, I know it's going to go here. An M. Night Shyamalan plot twist. Perfect.
Okay.
Perfect. The happening is there. Okay, now my turn.
Place a card.
Exactly what you'd expect.
Oh, boy.
Perfect.
This is starting to get hard.
Yeah,
exactly
now
what you'd
I'm starting
expect.
To lose my mind.
I love it.
Five. Oh, not quite. It glands deep. Okay. All right. I do not have any movement cards.
Mm-hmm.
So
I wish I could give you one.
No, it's okay. I think this is a good time to just
fight
drop,
the bird.
Drop these three cards.
Oh, nice.
Seven damage to the bird.
Okay. I'm gonna just give it 20 hit points and see
sure.
if that's hard enough to kill.
Okay.
Sure. So the bird's down to 13.
I think that'll be way easier.
That's too easy. I'll give it 40.
Okay.
Okay. Good.
Oh, my turn?
That was my turn.
Card.
Right. Preteens. I'm already standing there, so we
so now it's
double up.
Now
and
it's preteens. Preteens and Tom Cruise.
Preteens and Tom Cruise.
Are we even allowed to discuss that?
I don't know. That's a good
question. I'll leave it alone. 5 and 3, right?
Yep.
And look at this is egg paradise.
I still can't really go anywhere, so. Are you green?
Yes,
here's some cards.
Wow, how do we get him? How do we get? Well, I guess we have to throw him moves if he's stuck over there.
I don't know.
Well, there's no eggs near me.
He could just walk.
I can only. Oh, I could be, walk one. I forgot
you
I could just walk
step.
One.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, then give me that damn card back.
Yeah. Take one step.
And I'll step
this way. Yeah, probably better than giving him a.
I didn't know I could get a. I forgot I had a free move.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, you just don't have a distance.
Gotcha. That's better.
Okay. This is Lazenby, right? And Lazenby's card is third base.
Oh, does Lazenby ever move, or does his just stack up until he gets hit by an egg?
Unless he wants to move, I don't know.
That's fine. His can just stack up until he gets hit by an egg.
This is, okay. Well, let's hope we don't roll that space.
Okay.
Wait a minute, what was that one?
Third base.
Oh, okay.
William Shatner, third base.
William Shatner.
I shouldn't even tell you. I shouldn't even
that
tell
could
you.
Be
I knew it was William Shatner.
So we can table talk all we want as long as it's not our turn, and then when he gets hit by an egg, then it's like, okay, shut up, I have to do this. Right?
Yeah.
Okay, I like that.
Okay.
Because this is still getting too complicated to remember.
Yes,
yeah.
Exactly.
There's going to be one we just don't talk about, and that's going to be the one that gets us.
Oh!
But,
boom!
There we go. You thought this was going to be easy, Paul? It's not going to be easy.
All right.
I have nothing.
That was this guy's role?
Oh, that was
Lazenby's role. You didn't do your Cards Against Humanity.
Oh, that was Lazenby's role.
That was not your turn.
Oh, yeah,
now it's
right.
Your turn.
Now it's your turn.
I hope an egg drops near me. My card is Yeast.
I'm going to forget I've already forgotten half of these damn things.
Nah, you'll remember all of them, I'm sure. We're not getting to the hard part yet. When eggs actually start landing on Cards Against Humanity cards, where's the dice? This is my roll. 6-5.
Okay.
They're all over here.
That is the egg paradise to which I guess I should try to move. I will just do a 3 move to get close. 1, 2, 3.
Okay.
That's it. I'm close to an egg.
Okay. Oh, we're doubling up, and I'm not even remember what I'm standing on.
I forgot also.
I know Pac-Man's next to me.
Waka waka waka.
Ooh,
well, let's just hope they don't get hit.
It's the 3/5 compromise.
Oh my god.
Okay.
And on top of you, a card you don't remember?
I've totally forgotten that card.
Oh, the name of this game is...
Oh no, it's what you've come to expect.
Yeah, right.
So 3/5 compromise.
Exactly what you'd expect.
Exactly what you'd expect.
Uh-oh.
5-6. Well, I do not have...
This is not a random distribution of eggs. This is ridiculous. We have to play again.
I do not have a movement card, so I will just teleport.
Sure.
Okay, sure.
I'll teleport to here.
That's a pretty weak use for that special, but sure, let's go for that. Get yourself 3 cards.
Woo! All right.
It's not
somebody needs to fight the bird.
I did. Excuse shot me. The bird.
Oh, yeah, I know, but I mean again and again because
we're just not getting enough cards to do that with.
Don't forget your cards against humanity.
Brad. Right. I'll start here. Doing it in the butt. I hope I can remember that.
I remember it.
long ago.
And then I roll.
I'm gonna stick with I remember it.
three and two, right here. No, here, here.
Three, two.
Okay.
Yeah, it was right next to that. You took the only egg I could reach.
I'm gonna take this.
You
egg.
Took the only egg I can reach.
I did.
What
I
the hell? This is a cooperative game. What the hell's wrong with you?
Well, you should have said something because I could have. I took it because I can walk to another egg. From
you
there.
Played a teleport. Oh, I see. Because it was close to.
It was close to two.
It was close
eggs.
To me.
Okay, I'm done.
Lazenby's turn.
Oh, you took three. Okay, his card is.
Serfdom.
Serfdom.
Serfdom, William Shatner, and...
Something else.
Preteens.
Preteens? No, aren't preteens over on Tom Cruise?
I
wow,
forgot.
This
nope.
is getting hard
it's,
really fast.
No, I have no idea. I thought it was preteens. I have no idea.
Okay, well, as soon as we test this mechanic once, we're going to figure out how terrible it is. That happened. I don't have any move cards. So, thanks to Paul, I'm also not standing next to an egg,
mm-hmm.
but I'm standing next to Paul.
Hey, you want to trade some cards?
We fight. Yeah, I have. Here's yeah, here's green cards is good. What do you got? You got a move you could give me, asshole?
Yeah, sure.
Thank you. what color are you? You're blue, right?
I'm blue.
I need that for sure.
All right.
Do I need to give you any baggage to carry to your friends?
I don't think so.
No, okay. All right, that was a good trade.
Okay.
My turn. Hmm. All right, in the spot we're standing in, the Unstoppable Tide of Islam.
Did we not already see that card?
Yeah, we did. We, but only
we in the preview. We did.
Okay, okay, gotcha.
All right. 3-1.
It's Egg City.
Way over there. Well, I'm just gonna draw three cards.
Somebody fight the bird.
I did.
I know you did one.
No,
I'm saying
it should
happen again.
I've got a two that you just traded me.
I'm saying it should happen again.
Yeah.
My turn here. The tiger that killed my father will go here. God, there's so many damn cards. And then I roll the thing.
This is just a catastrophe.
Oh!
No, and we haven't hit a card yet.
Nothing.
Let's see, you get to go, though.
Oh, right. I have 1-2 move. I'll move 1-2 here. Draw three. And
that's pass. that's only a one move, but you had a free one.
Yeah.
Right, right. And I'll pass the turn.
Lazenby rolls. No, Lazenby draws. Lazenby should not draw. This is ridiculous. Thank God, it's a blank. But we have to remember that also.
There is a blank in there with William Shatner and other things.
These have to go on blank spaces. Something. Where you're standing is just not working.
I don't mind if it doubles up. The real problem is Lazenby. Like, if
no,
there's two
here's what's wrong with letting it go where you're standing, right? What's wrong with letting it go where you're standing is that...
It's not going to get hit as often.
It's not going to get hit as often. The whole point was that these things would get hit. And
right.
We're preventing them from getting hit.
Right.
We're extending the mid-game by letting them stack up, and we're making them harder to name off when they do.
That's true.
So...
They need...
This guy needs to draw
no cards, because if we draw
sure.
cards, we decide where they go. Him drawing a card is not interesting for anything.
Okay. I don't like us deciding where they go.
Why? It might help me remember what they
yeah,
are.
Yeah, maybe.
It might help me remember what
maybe.
They are.
Mm-hmm.
Where I put them on the board.
I guess it's mm-hmm. irrelevant where you put them.
It's pretty much irrelevant.
Because the die is going to, it's random anyway.
Playing cards against humanity is also pretty much irrelevant. So let's
yeah,
not
well,
stick with making
sure.
a strategic decision. I just want to put it, I have to put it in an empty space.
Right.
The purpose is not to, like, for that empty space itself to be meaningful, but for
and,
the board
and
to be getting.
We can do clever things like decide that all the people go over here and
right.
all the dirty
should,
ones
right,
go
we should
over
do
here.
That. That's an aspect of a co-op game.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
Okay, William Shatner goes up here because that's where the people are. And so it's slowly becoming code names. But
right, exactly.
But the board gets wider and wider. That's when the danger kicks in.
Yeah,
you're
yeah.
actually having to remember
no,
these
I,
things.
I like it.
Do we want to? Okay, whatever I roll next time, we're gonna have to. It's gonna be a card, because I want to test that mechanic
okay.
once. But then I would like to reset and try with an empty space,
okay, sure.
and with him not drawing cards.
Sure. Okay.
Okay. He doesn't take a turn, so it's my turn. I'm drawing a card. It is also blank. I'm putting the blanks here in the middle,
mm-hmm.
and then I am.
Make sure we don't have like a run of blanks.
Do we have a run of blanks?
There's quite a few blanks.
We didn't really shuffle.
Yes.
Oh, I'm rolling an egg. And that egg landed here because I want to test this mechanic.
All right.
Reset.
Okay.
It is your turn.
For God's sake.
I can't. We can't help.
We can't help
even
you.
Though I know exactly.
Is that William Shatner and preteens?
Is that your guess?
Yeah.
No, it's Tom Cruise and preteens.
Oh, it's Tom Cruise and preteens. Oh shit. Well, okay.
We lost a castle.
We lost a castle.
Hmm.
William Shatner's here.
Yep. Yeah. With a bunch of other stuff.
With a bunch of other stuff. Okay.
Good. I do like the ability to have two on a space, but I don't know.
I don't think it's an ability. I think it's. I mean, I remembered half of that. I feel pretty good about that. I get nothing for remembering half of that.
That's true. Mm-hmm.
Okay. I want to restart.
All right.
Okay.
Because we still have half an hour. We can play another full game of this.
How much time we have?
Well,
you got a watch.
I have a watch on my hand.
Okay.
The guy knows his time. Well, here's how I figured it out. There's a longer one here.
Whoa. It's not digital?
I haven't worn a watch in years, so.
What's that supposed to? How's that supposed to make me feel?
No, I just
are you watch shaming me, sir?
No, just my wrists.
I found the watch.
They don't like it.
Got to make sure it works.
Did I give you a watch?
Remember the Laura Croft watch you ordered?
Oh yeah. I don't. Those things are so bad.
I know. I tried to wind it and it wasn't working.
That's not a winding kind of a watch. That's a battery kind of watch.
Okay, then I tried to wind it.
This one winds itself. As long as I wear it for 8 hours a day.
Is it like, woo, windy, windy?
One of those kinetic things.
Well, I don't have to do this, although I do. But not with a watch on. That's ridiculous. Then it would be powered for weeks.
Like mine is.
It would keep me awake at night ticking.
That's how I keep my Fitbit up.
I said nothing. I'm not a part of this.
How many steps have
I'm using a Fatbit. It just tells me when to eat.
Totally innocent.
Have you had enough dessert?
Oh, have some more dessert.
I know you can't have dairy, but I mean, it is really yummy.
Let's do a quick overview of the rules for people who have joined us midway.
I was shuffling the cards.
The name of the game is Giant Bird. No, it's how about Mildly Frightening Gamble?
I know.
The name of the game is. I think Mr. Dragonbro is actually the best name.
Mr. Dragonbro.
Okay. The name of the game is Mr. Dragonbro.
How about Bird? Bird is the word.
Mr. Dragonbro, it is.
Okay. It was unanimous. A good conversation we had.
It's unanimous. Well, I'll explain. You can explain the rules as I set up.
Okay.
This is the Sura board.
I'm not sure I remember all the rules.
And the bird is trying to kill us.
All right, so the bird's trying to kill us.
We occasionally fight the bird by throwing fight cards at it.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Which would seem simple, and yet we seem to
It's going to take a few turns to gather up.
The game ends when all our castles are dead.
Or we deal 40 damage to them.
See, that's
or
we deal 40 damage.
That was we lose when all the castles are dead, rather.
Right, and the bird has 40 hit points.
Bird has 40 life.
Simple enough to hit. We can throw cards at him from anywhere.
Mm-hmm.
Every turn, at the beginning of the turn, first we draw cards against humanity card. These are mixed up now. All the blank ones are lost.
They're over here. Oh yeah. Look.
We draw cards against humanity card and place it in an empty space on the board.
It's fine if we get a blank.
Okay. We place it in an empty space on the board, and if an egg is ever dropped on that space, whoever's turn it is has to remember what card that is, or else we lose a castle. And if we lose four castles, we are dead. Mm-hmm. And I guess also eggs can just land on castles.
Yeah, totally.
So even if we have perfect memory, the game will still eventually end.
Yes.
And if all the spaces fill up with white cards, the game also ends. Although I'm not sure that's that is possible.
Technically, if it keeps landing.
Yeah, let's do that. Let's do that.
Okay.
So.
So then that way we wouldn't.
On your turn, first you do the card thing, then you drop a random egg somewhere on the board. Then you can do one action. The actions include, if you're standing on somebody, trading cards with them open-handed. If you're not throwing combat cards at the bird, if they match your color, so I can play green combat cards. Moving and picking up an egg, which is three cards if you get to an egg, or just handing any number of cards straight to one player, not a trade, but just you need these, and they can be any cards, but they're probably combat cards or movement cards for that.
Are we letting the trading happen? Can you move to trade?
If you land on an egg, you take the egg. If you land on a guy, you do the trade.
Got it.
If you just stay put, then you can fight the bird. Or throw cards at somebody. And so the movement is basically about grabbing the eggs.
Right.
So the board is relevant. Being distant from eggs was relevant in the last game.
Oh, definitely.
Mm-hmm. The colors are relevant because the combat colors are, you know.
Yep.
The movement cards, we're using the coins for movement just because that's how they have roughly the distribution that we want, although they're a little bit thin. And here's how it begins. Start us off. Whoops, sorry about that. I did that. I'll tell you what it is. Same time. Before you roll the dice,
he's got to do a card. You got to do a card.
Right. Mondor, we're not writing the rules down because there's just
because we're
streaming. A lot of them. Okay, so I'll start by, throwing a card out. And whatever, right? Farting and walking away.
Farting and walking away, which I just did.
Never done that.
Fell in the ground.
I like that. So anywhere?
Anywhere?
I'll just put it there. Just
okay.
Because.
Good. We can discuss. Are we sorting where the cards go? Like,
sure.
So farting and walking away went over there. So like maybe like, embarrassing things are here, sure. People are here, sure. And embarrassing people are right in the middle.
That's right.
Okay, whatever.
The more embarrassing right. They are, the more towards
we only have one thing to draw our categories from. Okay, so this is the orange axis, that's mm-hmm. one. This is the gray axis, that's five. And perfect. Egg drops here.
Perfect for you.
I'll that is take pretty cool. It. I'll take it.
He's got one free step. He doesn't have to play a card to go one free step. He's going to pick up three cards because he picked up the egg. We have eight egg pieces, so we've decided arbitrarily that there could be no more than eight eggs on the board, although I think that's never actually going to happen because mm-hmm. they're pretty easy to go grab. Mm-hmm. And that was his turn. Oh, we have a fourth player.
A ghost player.
Who does only one thing. In fact, he probably can just hang out at his castle for the whole game because...
He just rolls a die.
He just drops an egg.
He just okay. he just helps eggs drop.
He makes
turn.
Eggs drop.
Okay.
So that is five and four.
Oh, that's close. Hello.
That is close to you, Paul. But it's my turn.
It is.
No egg is close to me, but that doesn't matter because first I have to do this. Praying the gay away. That's almost as embarrassing.
As farting and walking
it's
away.
It's more embarrassing than farting and walking away.
Got it.
So they both end in away. That's the away corner.
That's the away okay. corner because it's away.
Okay.
Away.
That's now I drop an egg. Mm-hmm. And that's five and four.
Oh,
again.
Does it destroy my egg? Did we decide whether that happens in this?
Yeah, what's the egg on egg violence, I think?
Maybe it just doesn't happen.
Hmm.
Or it goes away, sure.
This bird is a harsh mistress.
Yeah,
I think
fine.
The egg destroys
a,
the other
it's
egg.
It's a co-op game,
that's
you
the
want
thing,
it to be harder.
That's the okay. most.
You always want it to be harder than
well, you do, but you can always make,
right.
This is not a balancing
right. Yeah, right.
But in terms of theme, an egg landing on an egg, my first reaction the first time it happened was they should both be crushed.
Sure.
So
sure.
I think that's right. Okay. So I've rendered the board completely useless, and on my turn I wish I could just draw a card. I shall give Paul those cards.
Thank okay. you.
You're welcome. That's oh, it's right. your turn, Paul.
It is my turn.
So we've decided that trading can just happen remotely.
That's not trading. That's gifting.
Gifting.
Right. We
gifting
were open hand trading and
okay,
we're standing
okay,
in the
gotcha,
same spot.
Gotcha.
Vehicular manslaughter. We'll just put that over here.
Okay.
Vehicular.
I'll just imagine an accident happening on that.
Right.
Well, I mean, an intentional accident.
Okay. Vehicular manslaughter.
Happening
right
on
there.
That space.
I'm
just picturing that in my head.
Six and three.
Well, that's close to you.
It is actually. I think I can.
It's too bad I gave you a crap ton of bird combat cards, Paul. Hit the bird. Don't run around, hit
all
the bird.
Right. Do I get to move one space when I hit the bird, or do
no.
I stand
no.
still and throw a rock?
Stand still and throw
a okay.
combat at the bird.
I do have a crap ton.
Because if a leg lands on you, you're
that's
gonna
right.
lose all your cards.
10 points.
See, I like that. That's one
and
quarter.
I think that
that's
if
one
lands
quarter of our victory, right. And here's what I love about that. We all start with cards, which means it feels like we're making progress until suddenly we run out of cards. Mm-hmm.
Right. I also think that if an egg drops on you, you go home and you don't drop the cards there, they're just gone.
They're just gone. That's fine.
Yeah,
that's
okay.
fine. We don't have another card.
That's like
the
don't
other,
save
we
up
have
the
other
cards.
Cards sitting on the board now, okay. So you're right. They should just be gone. Okay, so it's you. Card.
A kiss on the lips, which...
That's not too embarrassing.
This is embarrassing things, the scary things.
I guess this is a good corner. All right. This is the kiss on the lips right next to my cousin.
And then I roll this guy. Here?
Nope.
Well, this
no, it drops on your head.
It drops on my goddamn head.
We were just discussing what happens when that happens.
You
but there's no egg either, right? Broken egg.
Broken egg.
Card's gone. Man.
Card's gone.
You're going to miss those cards.
Okay.
That was going to be good. Shouldn't you start at your castle with a new hand?
Oh yeah, sure. Why not?
Okay,
here you go.
I'll take it.
I'm not gonna start you with
it's
zero.
It's average
cards.
And
that's
probably worse than what
that's
you had.
It's
punishing.
Worse than what you had, right?
What color?
Did,
am I did, purple?
You're purple. Yeah.
I did 10 when I attacked.
Cool.
By the way, so you should be down to 30.
I did.
Oh.
What? Oh, these got rolled. I put him at 30.
Okay.
These got rolled.
All right. So Lazenby's turn.
Oh, he doesn't get a card. He just gets an egg.
Which dropped right on.
Same spot.
Yep. Yeah, the bird loves that spot.
Someone in chat suggested that the egg drop should be the final action of a turn.
Wrong.
A lot of times you want to run to the egg that just dropped, so that
right.
that might not work the best that way. Yeah?
That's all right. They can just be wrong. So I'm going to. Oh, I got to do. This is my turn.
Yes.
I rolled for Lazenby. Now it's my turn.
Yep.
I'm doing the card. The card is licking things to claim them as your own. If that's not like a kiss, I don't know what is.
That's pretty good. Kissing and licking all over in that corner.
Oh, this is the kissing and licking corner.
Concerned, but.
It's my
egg.
Castle. All right, and the egg drops. 3-3. Well, that's close to me.
That's very close
enough that I can reach it? No, I have zero movement cards.
But you can move towards it.
I will do that. I want to get away from all this kissing and licking.
All right, my turn. Almost giving money to a homeless person. Almost. I think almost giving money to a homeless person can be.
It goes right with farting and walking.
Farting
away.
And walking away. Mm-hmm. Oh, I just. Oh, I've got. I'm gonna,
I've got a little something for
walking
you.
Walking away. That's more.
I've
about,
got a little something for you there, sweetheart. There it was.
And now the egg. One and one.
Oh, for God's sake.
The first.
Crushed my castle.
Okay, no, now it's my turn. You are purple.
Steal my egg. I dare you. I'm right next to
it. Oh, I'm gonna. I could. I totally could.
Get the white one.
The question is to get the white one or to give him some purple cards.
Oh, actually, he's got a huge handful of purple cards because he's flashing me his cards.
You should give me some purple
cards.
I'm gonna fire
off. And I should give you the doubler.
Oh, is that a doubler?
Oh, is that what that is?
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
It was a teleport last time, which was
no,
pretty
no,
useless.
No, the generic one was a teleport last time.
Oh, that's right. That didn't have color.
The no color one was a teleport.
Okay. Wow, a combat doubler. Well, we're going to win then.
I'm okay with that.
Yeah, that's BS. That no, I want to know how much it is without the doubler. Okay, so you are going.
I hate math. I think it's a lot.
All right, draw your card.
Okay. Mutually assured destruction. That will definitely go over here.
Next right. Vehicular manslaughter.
Right. I'll roll for the die or for the egg. I'm always forgetting which is okay. 3 and 4.
Yep.
And I'm just gonna fire this off. So that's 2, 4, 7, and 4 is 11.
Yep.
Times 2 would be 22.
You want to get the bird down to 8, or you want to get an?
Fine. That does something else.
So this does something else.
That does something else.
11.
11. All right. So we're down to 19. The bird is half dead. And all that even after you got crushed by an egg. So I think we should start you with less cards next time.
Okay,
so, see now I'm balancing. That's how good this game is.
Yeah, exactly. We want to make it better.
All right, Lazenby rolls an egg. And that's 6 and 3.
Right where there was one.
Oh, God. Okay. Idiot. And I get a turn in which I must place a card. A super soaker full of cat pee. What a lovely little collection we have over here.
Okay.
Farting, homeless people, super soaker full of cat pee, and another thing I don't remember.
Something, it ends in a way.
It ends in a way.
So farting and walking away, and
something that ends with a way. That's not enough words
no,
to remember that.
No,
oh my God, okay, I hope I don't roll that. Here I go, new egg. 4 and 1. I will take this egg and draw 3 cards. Please, sweet cards, be the cards I need.
All right.
This is why I'm confused, because I keep rolling for Lazenby and then drawing a card and then rolling.
Yeah.
Right.
I'm the only one who has that.
Vigorous card. Jazz hands. It can go over in the kissing and.
is that what you think that means?
And licking.
Awesome.
Vigorous jazz.
Vigorous jazz hands. I'm gonna have to make a note of that later on.
Got it. And then.
We don't have any people. We decided this was the people corner, and then we haven't drawn any people.
Right, exactly. 4 and 2. And I will just, I can move 5. I will zoom across the board. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Grab it. Yeah, grab those edge eggs. They're hard to get.
The farthest egg and get 3 cards. I will be done.
Okay, the dragon has 19 hit points. And we're soon to start losing castles. I believe, because we're soon to start hitting cards.
Spontaneous human combustion, we'll put that here.
Oh yeah.
Roll for my egg drop.
No. Boom! Dead
we'll
castle.
Just kill
dead
a castle. We are really bad at hitting.
Wow, we have not hit any cards
I
yet.
I can still move though, right?
Yeah, sure. You okay. Get a regular turn.
I'll just move 1 to get this.
Alright.
And I'll pass the turn.
Lazenby drops an egg. But he gets a, he doesn't have to name it, right?
Right.
Now I go and I put a card down. Puberty is right in the middle between all these other awful things.
Okay.
Puberty. My egg. 1, 5.
Again.
You shouldn't stand there, man. That's like
man.
Egg central.
All right.
There's been like the 3
Oh, goodbye,
eggs.
Good cards. Okay.
How many should I draw this time? 3? I drew 4 last time.
I'm gonna give you 3.
Okay.
I think 3 is about, I think 3 is exactly right. There, game done.
Cool.
Game balanced, it's over.
It's all good now.
Let's see. Oh, I have a teleport now. I didn't even look at the cards I drew. I have lots of move cards and no fight cards. This sucks. So much. Okay, well, I'm getting another egg.
Oh, now you have more cards.
Yep.
We've covered, yeah, I don't know how much percentage of the board we covered, but there haven't been any egg drops on cards.
Famine.
Looks bigger than it is. I mean,
famine.
We really haven't covered half the board.
Okay.
Famine can go over in that corner.
There's 3 4s out there, so we have now, I think, covered half. Wait, 3 4s is only 12 and there's 36 spots.
So we're
one third of the board.
Okay. I feel like we should take cards by now.
Well, that works too. We're just gonna kill every castle.
That works too.
With an exact hit. You took Lazenby off the board. That's not.
Sorry. He goes back home.
He goes back home. That's right. He got killed by the egg. He gets three more cards he can't use. Yeah.
Okay.
All right.
My turn.
Yep.
All right. So we'll draw here. Pictures of boobs.
That goes over with the puberty.
Okay.
And then I roll for the egg.
Four.
Boom, right?
Yep.
Okay.
Thank you.
I can't move. I'll just give these to you.
All right.
Nice. Lazenby rolls an egg. 3, 5.
Oh, it hits one. No, that's 3. That's 2, 5.
I have no idea what that card is.
Oh, we just put that down.
Did we?
But wait, isn't this Lazenby's turn, so he just gets a free pass. Unless somebody has to name it.
One of us has to name it on the...
Here's what I think. I think this is getting so hard. Yeah, it's not a free pass. It's any one of us can name it, right? If it's my turn, I have to name the card. If it's Lazenby's turn, we can all work together.
Right.
Well, that'll be a player when they're not, when we do it when it lies.
But even so, like, it's not one of the away cards. I think, is it the homeless person?
No, this is the homeless person. Oh, the farting walking away. This is the homeless person. This is the other thing that ends in a way. And this is...
This is the game if we don't know it.
I have no idea what that card is.
It's got to be something... Oh, is it... It's not vehicular manslaughter.
I thought this was too easy and that turns out this is too hard. Does anyone in chat
know
what
somebody tell us what that card is.
There's
Super
no idea.
Soaker. Super Soaker.
That's a Super Soaker full of cat.
Oh.
How did that get there? I thought that was at the other edge.
No, it wasn't in the violence thing. That was over the embarrassing thing. It is a Super Soaker.
Let's have a look. Chat window useful. It is a Super Soaker full of cat.
Okay.
The audience wins.
Okay.
All right, so, but the egg stays, right?
The egg stays.
Sure.
Okay,
sure.
The egg stays. The game continues. Well done, everyone,
Lazenby.
Including
okay.
everyone.
Thank you, Lazenby.
All right, that was Lazenby's turn. Okay, so now I gotta go. Oh, this is easy. A super soaker full of cat pee.
Okay.
We have 15 minutes. Let's design a different game. This is a tiny horse.
A tiny horse.
A tiny horse.
Yes.
I'm going to put it next to vehicular manslaughter, which is here, right?
Yep.
Okay.
Correct.
All right. 3 and 1.
Oh, close.
I do know some of these cards. I did not remember the super soaker.
I can't remember any of these damn cards.
All right, your turn.
How's my combat? Because fuck this dragon. I have 3. I'm throwing it.
Do you think you kill this dragon on the next?
No,
game?
I'm throwing
3.
Definitely
we're down to 16. That's all I got.
Okay.
All right.
Even though I'm standing next to 2 eggs, I'm gonna do that.
Catapults. We'll put it
next to the cat pee. Put it where the cat pee. Oh, you can't. There's a thing there.
Well,
that's all right. Put it here next to the one card we're sure we know now is the one that's gone.
Catapults. Okay. All right. And I will throw 8 more points at him.
Oh, nice. Okay, 8 more points from the dragon. Takes
him
down
to 8.
Oh,
I'm sorry. I didn't do the egg. Sorry.
Takes him down to 8.
5, 5.
That's...
Oh,
boy. Okay, maybe we don't kill the dragon.
I just put that there.
It was next to... I can't say, right?
Yes. It's next to vehicular manslaughter, and now it's next to catapults, and it was...
We read it out loud 3 times.
I know we did. It was...
I think we're all dead.
It was...
An unmemorable card, to say the least.
It is. It's just gone.
Yeah, I mean, I don't remember any of them. They're all.
It was. It was our death. I do not know the answer to this question. I was not paying close enough.
Let's ask the universe. What card is there?
What card is it?
We just put it there.
Right here.
What the hell? That's terrible.
It
I read it out
really
loud.
Bad.
I put it there because it was similar to vehicular homicide.
I really don't think that. I'm surprised I remember the first one.
You know what I think? I think it's hard enough if we all have to remember.
Yeah.
I don't think the active player needs to be burdened with this.
Maybe that's the expert version.
Well, right, but I mean, like, even with us thinking it's a tiny horse. Thank you.
It's a tiny horse. I should have totally remembered that.
We live.
How do you guys remember that?
It's a spectator game. We didn't remember it. It's there.
But how did they remember
it? All they have to do is run it back. I don't know how they remember it. There's a million of them.
Wow.
Somebody remembers. Like, there's only 3 of us.
That's
we
true.
Remember
like,
some of these cards.
They're assigning it.
We remember some of these cards, just not all of them. All right, excellent. We're still alive.
Okay, tiny horse.
I'm sure that if we played this game a few times, we'd become experts.
We'd get better.
Maybe.
We would get better. We would memorize the Cards Against Humanity cards eventually.
It's definitely a fun game.
If we play Cards Against Humanity.
I feel like I've already done that, but obviously I'm no good at it.
All right.
That was your roll, and you were going to hit the dragon for 8.
And
so now he's down to 8
and
points.
And I'm done.
Okay.
Your turn.
Your turn. So I'll start with this. The Hustle. Put that here.
Okay. I'm going to remember that no matter what.
Two and three.
Three and two. Nice. Safety. I love the danger element of the cards. I think we have to balance it, but I actually like it.
All move.
So in your face, Internet, we figured out something else to do with Cards Against Humanity cards.
Okay, I'm done. That was easy.
Lazenby says, an egg now lands.
5-1.
At 5-1. Where are the eggs? Oh, there's one white egg. Oh, there it is.
Oh, we're almost full of eggs.
And now it's my turn. My card is, oh, thank God, a tiny horse.
Okay.
This is Darth Vader.
Darth Vader.
I'm putting him in the people corner.
People corner.
Darth Vader. He was
Darth Vader?
The bad guy in Star Wars.
Okay,
you guys remember that, right?
Yeah,
he's the bad guy in Star Wars.
He killed Han Solo.
No. Ah, no.
No?
Spoiler alert.
Spoiler alert.
Someone else did.
Oh, okay.
Okay. And now, J.J. Abrams killed.
I hope everyone has seen the new Star Wars.
And good on him. You should go see it. It's really good. It's even better the second time.
Darth Vader doing the hustle.
I placed my card. I'm rolling my dice. I'm getting 6-1.
Touche! Lazenby!
Which is Lazenby getting a poor boy.
Ow!
And I'm gonna get me some cards. I think the best cards are here. Paul.
All right.
We have played a full game of this, and it's fun.
Grave robbing. Grave robbing seems embarrassing. Grave robbing.
Okay. Grave robbing seems embarrassing?
That's an embarrassing.
Only if you get caught.
2-6.
Farting and robbing a grave.
Farting and walking away. Boom! I remember that one.
Hey, wow. Actual triumph without assistance from the entire world. Nicely done.
Does that mean an egg pops there?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
All right. Yes.
No immediate benefit to you, just saving us
it's
from
okay.
destruction.
I'm down in egg town here.
Yeah, no kidding. All right. Lazenby gives us an extra egg. And that is 3-1. Oh, well, which crushes this one? Asshole.
My turn? Whose turn? Your turn?
That was my turn. That was
I took Lazenby's turn without you going.
Oh,
I'm
no
sorry.
Problem. Okay,
I'm
so
sorry.
Justin Bieber will go next to the hustle. Just because.
But farther away from people. I like that.
I'm
sorry I took the turn out of order there.
2-4. No, you're fine.
I was so excited.
I still can't go anywhere, so I'll just move.
Go between the
here.
Two.
Yeah. I have choices now.
On to the away card.
Okay, I am drawing my card. My card is Crystal Meth.
I know her.
That's so bad.
Where's a good place for crystal meth?
Probably over here next to Vehicular Man.
Everywhere is a good place. Well, okay, this is the empty space that I can choose that's near Vehicular Homicide.
Got it.
That's crystal meth.
Okay.
And if I place it just like this, you can tell that it starts with the letter C. All right, I drop an egg.
5-1.
Yay!
Oops,
I'm sorry, I've done that so many times now. Do I have a move? Wait. What color am I? My hand sucks. Who's purple?
Me. Pan him over.
God, I can give you 3. That's just not enough.
That's not really worth
it. I'm getting more cards. I have to play one of my infinite supply of move cards. I'm wrong about there not being enough of them in the deck. And I know I'm just prolonging the game, but I don't have much else to do.
All right. Explosions!
Explosions! Right in the middle.
Right in the middle. Next to...
whatever that was.
That's Darth Vader. Puberty.
Yeah.
Explosions and puberty. Those definitely go
those
together.
Those go together.
Okay.
Explosions
separate. 1-1!
Oh, nice. Nothing. Wait, did we decide that castle spaces kill castles?
I don't know that they
do. We don't need that now. Okay, yeah. Okay. So an egg lands here.
That's not a good... Okay. I guess I'm just going to take him down to half. He's at 4 now. That's what
nice.
I do on my turn.
Yeah. Take him down by half.
I think we're gonna kill this dragon. I mean, we should have died twice anyway, so.
Yeah,
well, kind of.
No, because I think the rules are that you can ask anyone who's watching.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, then we'll always
because
know.
Because this is a spectator game.
Okay.
Okay, that was my turn. It's your turn.
Right, okay. Cards Against Humanity. Sniffing glue.
Where's crystal meth?
Over here.
It's right.
We'll put it right here then.
There you go.
Okay.
4-4. Which is.
There. Nice. Are we out of eggs?
We're out of there. Oh, there's the last egg.
Last egg.
And I'll move here to get. We'll move here to get this one. Give you some options.
Okay, now I'm rolling for Lazenby in the right turn order. I'm dropping 5-2.
5-2.
Yeah, 5-2 is there. So what is? Oh, that's Darth Vader.
Yep.
I hope so. Okay.
Yay. Nailed it. All right, now I'm placing a card. chainsaws for hands. That's close to Darth Vader.
Sure.
He's more machine than man now, right? Just think that when you see that car. And you'll think, you know, double ash.
Double ash.
Double ash.
All right, your turn. Do you have 4 points in your hand?
Do I have 4 kill points? I'm green, right?
Yep.
I have drawn 0 green kills.
Nope.
He's definitely dead next turn, or next round.
He's definitely dead next round? Okay, so I die. So you're saying
you
I don't...
If you throw me purples, he's dead, right? So I'll just fire those off the next time it's my turn.
Right. If you're saying he's definitely dead, you already have it. Do you need him? Do you need these?
No, if you give me those.
Yeah, I'm giving you those. Yeah. Okay, that's all my right. That's my turn. Okay.
My turn. Scientology.
Wait,
where did Tom?
Is the board full?
No,
see, if the board is full, I think it ends. But we have a couple of empty spaces.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Scientology.
And full means like you can't place that in an occupied space. So we're getting really close to just filling up.
Mm-hmm.
But this should prevent that.
5, 1, 2, 3.
Well, that's the one
Scientology.
Well done.
We are out.
We're
of,
out of eggs. Okay.
All right. So, I'm not sure what to do since we don't have anything else to
kill
do.
It.
I don't know. I don't.
Yeah,
I can't kill it.
Give me kill power then.
There you
thank
kill
you.
Power just in case he gets hit with an egg and his
right.
Name goes
right. That
away.
Can happen.
Okay.
So draw your card.
Blank.
It's a blank. Are we just skipping the blanks?
Yeah.
Penis envy. That would go.
That
with...
should go close to puberty.
Sure. It was somewhere around.
Even though that's nothing like what it means.
Puberty. And then we roll.
Then you roll over the egg. 3, 2. And, oh, it hits me!
You get hit.
Oh, damn.
And then I kill the...
How can you get hit when there's no egg?
Kill the,
I don't know. It's an empty egg.
It's an empty egg, right. It's an empty egg.
And we kill
and
it.
We killed it. All right, good. Well,
there's only one castle left.
Great. Set the difficulty. Ship it.
We got, we kind of figured...
Balance it and ship it.
I think it works.
Yep.
That's fun.
Yeah, that was
fun. I like remembering what the cards are.
Yeah.
I really hate forgetting what the cards are, which I think is the same thing.
Yeah, pretty much.
Joe, we got it.
Yeah, let's make fools play this.
Boom. Okay, well, let's clean up real quick.
Hello.
What are you doing?
Were you watching?
I was not.
Awesome.
Even
that's
better.
Why? I'm excited because
you guys
I don't know
either?
Anything.
No, okay. I was not doing my job.
All right, good.
Okay. I was doing my job,
and
but
who
another
else is
part
playing?
Of my job.
Me.
Ricky.
All right, come
I'll
on
care
in.
About dragons, eggs, and some kind of cards.
So just to introduce ourselves, I'm Emily. I'm the community manager here.
Cassidy, I work for James as of an hour ago.
As of tomorrow.
As of tomorrow. But I'm here anyway.
Sorry.
Come on over here. Start over.
Okay, what is this?
We'll set up. You introduce yourselves again now that you're in frame.
I'm Emily, you know me. I'm the community manager here.
I'm Cassidy, I work for James as of tomorrow.
I'm Ricky. I'm just here.
Shall I?
With a beautiful t-shirt.
Yeah.
Yes.
All right, everyone. The name of the game is what? Mr. Dragon Bro?
Mr. Dragon Bro.
We're going to work
like
on that.
It.
So
it's in flux there.
No, it's not in flux.
Oh, I'm
there
sorry.
There is no Mr. Dragon Bro card in flux.
No, I didn't. Oh, yeah.
So this is Mr. Dragon Bro, the guy on the board, and he wants to kill us.
Okay.
This is a cooperative game where we're trying to kill Mr. Dragon Bro before he kills
Sounds
us.
Sounds good.
He has 40 hit points, and the way you kill him is pretty simple. You throw cards at him that have skulls on them, but those skulls have to match your color. So it's for 4 players.
Okay.
If you're blue, you can kill him with the blue skulls, but the other color skulls go to other people.
Got it.
And so that they can throw him at the dragon.
Okay.
A strange and artificial restriction that has nothing to do with real dragon killing.
Okay.
And yet we need it for the mechanics.
It's ammunition for your special magical gun.
So here, the only thing that's in the deck, we're gonna ignore these specials right now because we're not sure what they do.
Okay.
So whenever you play them, make up what they do,
sure.
And that'll make the game better. But we really have 2 kinds of things in the deck. We have the colored combat cards, and we use these money cards for movement.
Okay.
So these are actually movement cards, and because you have to pay to move
farther
places,
than you were going to, you have to hire somebody.
You
to
can
take
move
you
one step for free, and every 2 coins rounding up is another step. So that's a 3-step card. It's just got 3 lines of coins on it. That's a 2-step card because it's got. Right?
Yep.
That'll take you further. Steps are squares on the board,
okay.
Not diagonally, just orthogonal, and that's how movement works. We're gonna start. Who wants to be what color?
I call black.
Okay,
yes.
So that's black. You're actually gold.
I'm gold.
Your fight
just
cards are gold.
Just kidding.
Your fighting cards are gold. Red is actually purple, blue is blue, and green is green. That's
okay.
The one. That's the colors we have in the deck. Color?
Green.
Okay.
Blue.
Paul, you in this?
They're supposed to play without us.
Oh, they gotta play without us?
They can play with, as long as there's not really any strict rule about it.
Paul.
Okay, I'll jump in.
There
sure.
you go.
Okay.
All right, Paul
okay.
and I will sit out. But we are still playing because spectators are allowed to kibitz, and you're going
Perfect.
To be so glad that we're helping.
Yes.
Okay.
I'm glad you're here to help me through this because I am very bad at picking up.
It's been a lot of.
Oh, you'll pick this one. This is no problem. I'm gonna start everybody with three cards.
Okay.
Every time you die, you go back to your home castle space, and you get three more cards. So dying's not all that bad.
Is it? Can we not show our cards to other people?
You can't show your cards to other people. Okay. Sometimes you can share, but we'll talk about that in a second.
Okay.
On your turn, let's see. I'm one. That's not helping. You're two. You're gonna go first.
Okay.
On your turn, the first thing you must do is choose. Are these shuffled?
Mm-hmm.
Is choose a Cards Against Humanity card. Share it with the group. Oh boy. A bunch of idiots playing a card game instead of interacting like normal humans. This is a longer card. You're gonna share this with the group.
Perfect.
And then you're all gonna decide where on the board you wanna put it.
Okay.
Because after we put it face down, we never get to look at it again, but we may be required to remember what it says.
Oh god.
Okay? So this card, a bunch of idiots playing a card game instead of interacting like normal humans, where would you like it to be?
Never. Anywhere.
Okay. Well then we're gonna put it right here.
Okay.
And That's your first part.
Okay.
Second part is the bird, dragon, creature is going to drop an egg somewhere on the board, and you're going to roll these dice to figure out where that is. All right, so this is the orange axis. So 3 by 5 drops an egg there. We have 8 eggs. If we run out of eggs, we don't drop another egg. Except we drop an empty egg, basically.
Yeah, yeah.
It does the damage
that
an egg does, but
it just doesn't leave
if an egg lands on another egg, those both eggs are destroyed. If an egg lands on a person, that person is killed and the egg is destroyed, and the person goes back to his castle and throws away his hand, draws 3 more cards. Otherwise, hey, it's an egg. It's got 3 cards in it. If you go to it, you get to draw 3 cards. So now that you've done the automatic parts of your turn, you get a choice of 3 actions. I think it's 3. One, you can move. You get 1 free step and you can play the coins to go farther. Then if you land, if you get to an egg, you can pick up the egg and get 3 cards. If you get to another person, you can swap cards in your hands and help give each other cards you might need. So like all the fight cards for her go to her, all the fight cards for you go to you. If you don't move, you can throw cards at the dragon. You can fight him with cards of your color. So you just dump all the cards that you're green. You throw all the green cards at him and take him down from 40 hit points. Or you can throw any cards to any single player. So you're not exactly trading, but you're saying, here, I sent you a gift. So you can send them move cards if you think they need move cards. You can send them fight cards that match their color.
Okay.
And you don't have another like null option. You can't draw a card or anything like that.
Nope.
So what would you like to do?
Who's blue?
Who is blue?
I am blue.
Give him some fight cards. So you can give him more than one if you have them.
No.
No? Okay, give him one of the move cards if you don't want to use them. Yeah, okay. So yeah, she gave you a fight card and a move card.
You're welcome.
And
trades?
No, that's just a gift.
Just hold on,
that's
huh?
Right. She
All
has
right.
to be next to him to trade.
I see, okay.
Or on the same space. Alright, your turn begins with this.
Dem titties.
Dem titties. Where would you like dem titties?
Oh, goddamn.
Somewhere. You try to remember them in chronological order and just play them
yeah.
in a spiral, right?
Sure.
Right? We could try.
That
Except I've
time.
Already forgotten the first. No, I haven't forgotten
no,
the first
I
one
know,
yet.
I
but, all right, where would you like it?
Where can I put it?
You any empty space?
How about. I don't know, right next to my castle, I guess.
Right here?
Yeah.
Dem titties
like
is right there.
Yeah.
Now, well, I haven't told you about these cards and how you activate them. If an egg falls on a card,
mm-hmm.
then the group. We had it as the active player, but now it's the group because we're trying to be nice. Has to remember what that card is, or else we lose a castle. If we lose all 4 castles, we die.
Okay.
If an egg falls directly on a castle, we lose that castle. But we can also lose a castle if we forget what one of these cards is. So, dem titties, card game. And now you roll for a new egg.
1 in 4.
Bam. So you can throw combat at the dragon. You can run get that egg.
We can give cards to somebody else.
Maybe in the advanced game you can just walk into a card to clear it. This is dem titties, I'm sick of worrying.
I'm sick of remembering this,
I'm getting rid of it now. Of course.
Can you do more than
if you remember it, why are you worried about it?
Wait,
can
so
you do
objective,
what?
Can you do more than one attack?
Yeah, you can throw all the cards you want.
Objective wise, do you want to kill the dragon?
You gotta kill the
also...
dragon before we lose all of our castles.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I'm just gonna attack with 2 attack cards.
Okay, so that's 6 points of damage. The dragon loses 6 hit points.
Suck it, dragon.
Down.
Suck it, dragon.
Uh-huh.
34.
Suck
okay.
it, dragon, bro.
All right. Who's in? You playing?
Yeah. Oh, my turn. Okay.
Yep.
the experienced player, the veteran.
Blank. Blowjobs for everyone.
Sure. This is
cards against humanity. We'll put it next to Dem Titties. Just seems to be on.
That's where they go.
Can someone roll for the egg for me?
The egg roll is. That's what we should call it.
Egg roll.
Egg rolls. There you go.
All right.
And
I don't care. Now we're calling an egg roll.
I will pick up this white egg.
Step one.
From
Cheap
Ass Games.
Yeah, that's what I need. Is it? It's just a rule book because you already have the from all these other games.
Three cards. There's two.
All right, you got an egg and you got three cards out of it.
And that's my turn.
That's that.
Okay. Now it's my turn.
First white card.
All right. Okay. The little engine that could. So that is gonna go.
Next to blowjobs for everyone.
Yeah, obviously.
Did everybody get that? The little engine that could?
The little engine that could.
Okay.
Choo choo.
Drop an egg.
Oh, no! That
is the green castle.
Why, Emily? I thought we were friends. I told you it was bad.
Oh, that's right. It's gotta be an empty space, right? Okay. Well, that was awful.
That was.
You are now.
Your face is awful.
A little.
Why is this
less
like
than,
par for the
really
course?
Really, less than a quarter of the way dead.
It feels
like you're a quarter of the way dead, but it's easier to hit the castles when there's more of them.
That is true.
It's the same as like when it feels like you're doing damage early because you started with cards.
Right.
Yeah, I like that.
Yeah.
It's strange because you want games to accelerate. This one actually slows down, but that's good.
It slows down, but it does accelerate because it gets more and more crowded with.
Oh, the danger accelerates.
Yeah.
Okay, so sorry, we're doing
no,
design.
No, you're good.
Right here.
That's what this is for.
So.
So now I make a move or a.
Action. Let's take a look at your hand. You've got the special.
Well,
you can make up what that does. Like this is the beauty of this.
Oh, so I can like attack with that.
I don't know what you can do with it.
I'm gonna say that I can
move to the castle or the guy of that color for free, maybe.
Oh, move to the guy. Sure, move to the guy. I like that.
Move to the guy? I want to move to the guy.
Which is closer to
And if
to
you
that.
Play your own, you can move to any guy.
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
So the
that's what the guys do now.
No, you can move to the. Oh, you're gold, right?
Yeah.
So you can move to anybody.
Yeah, you can move to anybody by playing that. That's a teleport for you. Or you can move to any space or anybody.
Anybody.
I'm gonna. Well, but I want to protect my castle, don't I?
Nah.
No.
All right, then I'm gonna move over here.
There's no protecting there. All the attack is coming from the sky. All right, so you want to go here? You want to go visit that guy?
Yeah.
Okay. Now you can trade with that guy.
So you can trade cards with him.
Oh, okay. You're over here, right?
Yep.
Do you have any gold?
You can give her cards too.
Yeah, anything that would help her, yeah.
Hey, thanks, friend.
Cool, all right. That happened.
Chat's just hungry.
I'm hungry,
yeah,
I hear that.
A manhole.
A manhole.
You
should put that right next to
a manhole.
Or
can I go under the egg?
No,
it's got to go empty space.
All right.
So, yeah, I'd go there.
A manhole.
Don't fall into that.
All right. 4 and 6.
That is that card.
It's this card. So what is that card? I guess we can all...
Blowjobs for everybody.
That is correct.
Yeah, but what's the card? All right. All right.
Hey-ho!
Correct. If we had not gotten that right, and it does get harder, then we would have lost the castle.
That would be sad.
So, yeah.
That would be very sad.
No, I want to move. You said I get one for free?
You get one free
and
step.
Then I can add
and then
two.
You can, that's two more.
Okay, so 1, 2, 3.
That'll get you there.
Yay, egg.
Three cards.
And that's it?
Yep.
Yeah.
Depression.
Aw.
That goes at the opposite end from blowjobs for everybody.
It's gone.
Yeah, let's put it next to the white castle over there, the gold castle.
I'm still gonna remember that space. All right, what is this again?
Depression.
Bummer.
And now egg roll.
4 and 5.
Uh-oh.
Boom.
I know what that one is.
That was the board game one. No.
The boring one?
Manhole.
Yes!
Manhole.
Really?
Yep, that's manhole.
Oh, I didn't even know that.
Because it was next to blowjobs for
heavens. All right, good. You survived. You survived a castle destruction. Now what would you like to do?
How many cards did you move to that egg right there?
One step is free.
Yeah, one step is
free. All
right, you want to grab this one?
Yep.
Okay, so that's three cards.
Oh.
Really clear in these eggs. This
the heart of a child.
Aww.
Put that next to depression.
Aww.
That's my childhood right there. Too real. I'll move.
Oh, no, roll for the egg.
That's just an egg. That's how Asian kids grow up. That's just how it is.
I'm going to die now.
Roll for my egg real quick.
I will be happy to roll for your
egg.
If
you're just tuning in, this is actually Honesty Hour.
Boom!
Oh,
That's how you lose castles right there. Damn, okay. That's how you get ants.
Okay. And I can move 4, 5, 6. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Pick this guy up.
Yep.
Spend 2 cards.
To get 3.
For 2 for 3.
Fight cards. You hope. There's 3.
And we'll see how this works here. Okay, I can live with this.
My turn.
Yep.
So I know what color this is, but what color is it now?
Red.
Okay. My card is free ice cream, yo!
Wow, yay! It's too bad the blowjob space is covered.
Let's go here.
Okay, free ice cream, yo, over here.
Free ice cream, yo. All
does right. It really say yo on it?
It really does, actually.
Free ice cream, yo. All yo. Right.
Hey, we gotta go back to Dragon Bro.
I'm so glad that Herds Against Humanity
okay,
is hip.
Thank you.
They
so
are.
Now
these guys are hip.
I egg roll.
Way over there.
Yes, far away.
Dead zone.
And then I can. This is movement, right?
Yeah, one, so that's one movement point. All right. You got, well, you got
and
one
I have,
free
so
move.
Two.
Right.
So I'm going to go.
Egg, right?
Oh, yeah, over here.
Yeah.
Hey, look at that. I got an egg.
Oh, that's 3 cards.
I'm a pro now. Not really.
I give you this. Yes!
Calculating every mannerism so as not to suggest homosexuality. Oh. Put that by ice cream.
Okay.
Sure.
I would have put it next to the other complicated.
It goes by ice cream.
It's okay.
I would, if I was playing.
If you were playing.
But I'm not, I'm just teaching.
We're just teaching.
Right? We all have to play
this
our first game, right?
We have to make the game exciting.
1-3.
1-3.
How do you let the Wookiee win in a cooperative game?
Be on the Wookiee, play with the Wookiee.
Play with the Wookiee. Yeah. Well, that's what I would have said. I would have suggested.
1-3-1. That is, nope, that is 4.
3-1.
Okay.
What is that card?
Hmm.
Oh, I think,
shit.
Oh, I think I know what that is.
It's not depression, is it?
Can we help
depression?
Yeah, everyone can help.
Okay,
yeah,
this is
help.
Depression.
Like, even kibitzers can help.
Is that the child, heart of a child?
Heart of a child,
this
yeah.
This is heart of a child. This is depression. This is not that.
This is not that.
Wait, there's no castle in that
is
corner.
This ice? No, that's ice cream.
Oh,
I'm
you lose
cream,
a castle.
Right?
Oh, you lose
this
one
is,
castle.
What's the one between the ice cream and the whatever this is?
Chat, help!
All right, blowjobs happened.
That says,
titties are
that
there.
Says it a jackal, so... I don't know what.
You know, why do people
chat? I don't know what English that is.
This is not a trivia hops.
This is a joke. I don't really get it. Oh, trivia hops. Thank you. Sorry, forgetting my own channels and jokes.
Oh, the little engine. That's the little engine.
The little engine. Yes, it is the little engine. Yay!
Okay, guess the little engine.
Yeah,
are you
yes,
gonna go with that?
Let's find the final answer.
It's down there somewhere.
No, it's way over by blowjobs.
How do you say that?
No, I said it should be by blowjobs. I don't think.
Oh, you don't think that's where they put it? Okay, well then that's fine.
I think it's the little engine.
Wait, where's the calculating every mannerism to pretend you're not?
That's
that
one.
That one. Yeah. Okay.
So it's gotta be.
Then this is a little engine that.
All right.
All right. That is the guess. It is.
Thanks, chat.
All right.
Thanks.
Thank you, the internet and everyone else.
And
the egg drops there. Right.
Yeah.
Yay. So this is a teleport.
Yeah, to a person.
To a person?
Yeah.
Any person you want.
I don't want a person. We're all kind of hanging out over here. It's true.
Well, no, it's, well, I don't know, it's her color. Should she teleport anywhere
that's
with
what
her
I'm
own
saying.
Color? You can go anywhere you want with that.
Yay.
Because it's your color.
Egg. Yeah.
Yay. We'll see how balanced that is over multiple games.
Right. We'll test. We'll build a game and then we'll play it lots
of times.
You guys
feeling like this is going to.
And we'll test and see if it's balanced.
This is moving outside.
I'm glad I know that because I got a lecture from a very important game designer.
Oh, thank you.
About how to do that. No, it wasn't you.
Oh, good. Thank God.
It wasn't you. One person in the world knows who I'm talking about.
He stay it!
I sold him a game and after he made a lot of money with it, he sat me down and said, here's
how
you make
a
game.
Oh, great. A snapping turtle. Biting the tip of your penis.
Well, that's
I can't say that I know what that's like.
You know, let's put it right next to them titties.
Sure.
Sure.
That's what that was. All right, good. Well, that's going to be a dangerous place to stand.
And roll for your
egg roll. 3-1.
Dead egg.
Oh, you blew up the egg.
You blew up an egg that was there.
Cool.
2 eggs makes 0 eggs.
You can move though.
That's egg math.
Yep.
You
can take your turn.
Move.
You can attack. You can
trade cards.
Wow, there's no eggs.
Who's next? Cards
next to me. Me and Emily are right here.
Well, they have 4
Emily,
people.
Emily, I like
to be only
red.
Red. One guy didn't clear.
That's
in
true.
In fact, he added eggs.
Like
he added eggs.
Interesting.
You can trade infinite number of cards too.
Oh yeah.
Here. You can give her however many she can give.
To one person.
You pass a bunch to one person.
Alright.
So, are you
and
gold again?
I would like to
use.
I'm red.
You're red. Well, you're red.
2 attack cards?
No, you're trading is your action. Or gifting is what your actions.
Alright, I'm done gifting.
Yep.
So, I just keep these.
Yep.
Okay, good. Your turn, my friend.
Daniel Radcliffe's delicious asshole.
How do you know that?
This card is missing an A.
I'll put that, you put that anywhere you want.
Okay, well, we are going to put Daniel Radcliffe's delicious asshole right here on the birds.
I wonder how he feels about that card.
Did I roll off the die?
Play it, play it. It's a one.
It's a one, one and four.
Four and one.
That is
depression.
Is
it? No, it's not.
That is not depression.
No.
That's the heart of a child.
Yes.
Yes.
It's the heart of a child.
And then I can do stuff. I'm gonna move to Emily's
around.
Square.
Right, we got one from the internet. Yeah, right.
I'm gonna give you gold. Do you have purple cards to give me?
Maybe. Yeah. Are you on the same spot?
You gotta be on the same spot.
Oh,
cool. Good.
Wait.
Are they following the rules?
Yeah, sure.
Gotta make sure they're following the rules.
Never break the rules. We'll just make them new ones.
That's right.
All right, cool.
Well, this game is balanced better for, you know, three real players and one,
and a fake one.
One fake one.
We'll have to figure that out.
Balancing is, you know, tomorrow.
Yeah, I'll pass my turn.
After dinner,
yeah.
Awesome. All right, I have a lot of things in my hand now.
What color are you?
But I'm gold.
Man, look at all the hit you can do. Drop that hit before you get landed on.
Do I just drop it?
Take your turn, right, but yeah.
Finally finishing off the Indians. That's not even kind of correct.
No.
But okay, we're gonna play it.
Okay, finally
right
finishing
there.
Off the Indians. Goes there.
Right there. And, alright, here.
Roll the.
You gotta drop it.
Where did they go?
2-5.
Oh, what is that?
That is, not ice cream. It is,
carefully calculating your.
Every mannerism your sexuality? No, wait, stop.
No, not that one. Not this one.
Maybe it is, though.
Oh, that one.
That's where the eggs
are. Shoot, what is that one?
It's like ice cream.
It was the one that Dan picked up and put anywhere.
Dan?
I kind of want to. Okay, it's Daniel Radcliffe's asshole.
Yeah.
There you go.
Delicious.
That just
asshole.
Happened.
Delicious.
This is not going well for us. Thank you.
Now I do stuff.
So I can just.
I think we're on our way.
Can I?
You just throw them down.
More and more
they're
cards.
Already like half
use
done.
Up your move.
Just go like that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Just drop it. How much is that?
That's a lot.
That's a lot.
Eight.
Eight off of 14 is.
Oh right. Okay. Six. Sorry, I forgot that whole thing. But I get it now.
All right, you're at 26 hit points on Yon Dragon.
Okay.
All right. Good teamwork, everybody. Gotta take down that dragon.
Getting married, having a few kids, buying some stuff, retiring to Florida, and dying. Could be worse.
That doesn't sound
I think
that
the
bad.
Only thing we
no.
need to do is
doesn't
just have
we
a sort of
this?
Minimum egg population, so if we would have destroyed our
right
last
now.
Two eggs on the board, we just roll another
Florida.
One.
Florida's here.
Sure.
Right?
Or it won't destroy
Florida.
The last egg.
Florida.
No, I've just had to just roll another egg. Why not? You know, more chaos is good, right?
6 and 2.
To get more cards into the thing.
To get more eggs on
maybe.
The table.
Maybe.
Right? Without an egg,
or
there's
maybe,
no reason to go anywhere.
Or maybe
no
if there's
we'll
no
there.
Eggs on the table, you roll three eggs so they can grand on it.
Well,
So
if there's one egg on the table, you kill it with another egg.
You totally
egg,
have a thing. Okay.
Sure.
Where are you?
Just make sure there's a minimum egg count.
There's an egg.
Yeah. Okay, for those of you writing the rules watching this at home, Paul and I have decided to add a rule, which is that there is always at least one egg on the table. That means that if an egg kills the last egg, you roll another egg.
Or if somebody picks up the last egg
or whatever, yeah.
Well, you wait till the next person's turn and see what.
Yeah, yeah, you're gonna make this check after the
so
egg,
you,
and right? then maybe make
do
another.
Do I get to attack people, or can I only trade?
No, you trade.
You're
trying to do that was your action for the
trade,
turn.
That was my action.
Yeah, trading. Okay. Trading was it. See, I missed that card. Now I can't help.
Nope.
We're over here making the game better. And
yeah, get a ruby too.
Sunshine and rainbows.
Aw, that's positive.
Sunshine and rainbows.
Let's put it next to.
Are you sure that's not a typo or something?
Florida next to Florida.
Let's put it next to Florida.
Next to Florida.
Aw. See, that doesn't seem like against humanity. It's like pretty decent.
Just you wait.
What's this one again? Oh, see, but it's next to the closet of your homosexuality. So.
No, that's here, isn't it?
That's here, yeah. The first one. I'm not going to tell you what that is.
Shoot.
I know what that is.
Well,
I know what
that
it
was pretty amusing to me.
6-2. That is a card.
6-2. And what card is it, players?
I put that down.
Thank you,
I don't remember.
God, hold on.
Yes.
They forgot.
No help from the audience this time.
You're not the boss of them.
That's true.
I know, I'm just helping
them.
Yeah,
I'm the boss.
Decide
I'm
what
the
to
boss
do.
I'm helping the game.
Tomorrow.
That's right, I'm not. I'm just suggesting that they don't help.
I have no idea. I really don't know.
I don't remember that one.
I have terrible memory.
Good thing I do too.
Yeah, it's not good.
You guys might be losing a fort.
No! Shh! I think your face is mean.
If the card says losing a fort.
No, it doesn't. It totally doesn't. That card is something about. Wait, this was depression, right?
Yes. I think so.
Why did I put that one there? I put
is
it
that
there
the snapping turtle biting the tip of your penis?
No, no, that one's of tears.
I love this game.
We had someone that would have helped, but they don't remember.
I come on, internet!
You most of all.
Nice.
All right, well, I don't know.
We I think they're done.
Better take a guess.
Okay.
Take a guess.
I think I got two guesses.
Yeah,
okay. You guys are fine. You get two guesses left.
I have no
left.
Idea. We can't just guess forever. That's like some kind of rule where you're done guessing, or
that's called the social contract.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Do we have anybody over there?
I was never good at those.
Left side of the table. Nobody.
I know.
Nobody?
Most gamers aren't.
I have no idea.
Finally finishing off the Indians. Yes.
You think so?
Oh,
you sure?
Yeah. They told us.
They did. Thank you, intern. It's a terrible card.
All right, you got it.
Thank you, Sabathis.
I would say this is an invalid playtest, except that we may never play this game again.
I mean, who knows? This could be the next hit.
All right, do your thing.
My turn?
Are you kidding? Max Tempkin's buying this tomorrow.
You can move now.
Can't remember.
It's already up on Kickstarter.
Right.
My turn. Being fat and stupid. Very nice.
What is it?
Being fat and stupid.
Oh, right
there.
Right there.
So bad.
Okay,
right
so...
there.
And an egg roll.
Oh, right. Yes. Right here. 4-4.
Nope. Next to blue.
Is it blue? Oh. Thank you. Okay, and now I can do things.
You can.
Let's see.
Move to an egg.
Yeah.
I can just use this one, right?
Yep.
Cool. Nope, that's not.
Wait. Yeah, that's fine. Good.
Yay!
Yay!
I got another egg.
Three cards.
All right, not my turn now.
Some sort of Asian.
Where can you put that where you can remember?
Hmm.
I feel like there's no right answer to that question.
How about that?
Put it on the characters.
Corner right there.
Yeah, we'll put it in the corner. All right. And then I go.
Some sort of Asian language. That's easy.
One six.
Hey, what is that?
That is that card up in the corner.
What is that card? I have no recollection of what that card is.
Yay, Asians. Okay.
Some sort of Asian.
Some kind of Asian.
Got it.
That was too easy.
Done.
No one asked.
And the egg goes there.
Okay. Free egg. And the unit action.
And purple. Who gets the purple cards? Red.
Oh, I'm purple.
Okay.
I'll take them.
Nice.
Foreskin.
Perfect.
For next to them titties and whatever turtle, snapping turtle.
There we go.
Yeah, that's an easy corner to remember, and I'm sorry it's so easy.
Thank you, Lackey. I appreciate that sentiment.
All right, and
we learn our lessons. Slowly.
Actually, I'll just do
and
it.
And painfully.
I'll just do it right now.
All right.
1-1.
Joe, you don't like cards against humanity?
I also hate cards against humanity.
Really?
Anybody remember that corner?
Like who knows this card? We got an egg drop on the corner.
That one was
that...
free ice cream, yo!
Yeah!
Oh, nice!
Free ice cream!
Yeah,
I think that's true, yeah. It's even got the yo in it.
Yeah.
Alright.
Cool, okay. I'm just going to attack.
Alright,
for five.
5 points. Takes us down to 21.
Okay. Done?
Card. Yep.
Done. Okay. Start here. Wiping her butt.
That corner's getting full.
Sure, we'll put that over yonder. And we'll roll for the egg. I really hope it doesn't hit me.
That is a 2 and a 4. It does not hit you.
Okay, and then I'll fire hella purple cards at this dragon.
Oh, hella purple cards, whoa! Dang.
Whatever that number is.
Whatever that is, he says. All right,
13.
6. What, 13?
Yep.
How do you know that?
That was fast.
How can you possibly know
that?
Counting
over. I know. All right, 13.
Whatever,
so...
I like Cards Against Humanity, I don't care.
I mean, I liked it the first few times I played it, but
then
every single time I hung out with anybody, they wanted to play Cards Against Humanity, and then I didn't want to leave the house because I got tired of playing that fucking game.
Ooh, okay, we just got Dragon is down to 8.
Whoa, we got this,
guys.
Oh, it's my turn. This year is a mass shooting. Yikes. This year? Really? Okay.
This month's mass shooting.
This week.
Political! Hashtag political.
Okay. All right.
So now I'm
Drop this egg roll.
I think it's really easy to tune the difficulty, right? Because you can talk about many people were allowed to remember.
Right, that's
I don't remember which direction it goes. It's like 2.
5 on the bottom, 2 on the top.
Where are we? We're
2-5.
We're here. You said 5-2, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay. That's a funny. What a
nest egg.
I must apologize. I honestly thought when we came in here this would not be fun, but I'm having fun.
That's okay. It's me and Paul.
That's right.
You don't have to be
I'm disappointed that you thought so little of us doing this.
People have to learn.
They do.
Many of the greatest things that have been done by us.
Yes. And many people would agree with that.
Took an egg. Those
get people, that egg.
Those poor people.
Draw them a
card.
You have 3.
Those poor people really
What's
need
our
to
HP
get
on the dragon?
Off of the Twitch
stream. 18. You got this?
You got
Where
this?
We at?
Thank you.
Here?
Yes.
Your card?
Vegetarian options. Aw.
Vegetarian options.
Can't put that with
too bad the Indians are gone.
Yeah, too bad Daniel Radcliffe's asshole's gone.
Oh, this
right
game.
There.
We'll put vegetarian options up here.
Next to where Daniel Radcliffe's asshole used to be.
Used to be. I think he might be vegetarian.
So how many times have those words?
6 and 3.
How many times have those words been said?
I think they were said on set fairly often.
Well, because Cards Against Humanity is not typically a positional
game.
Mm-hmm. So even in this context, I think it would be hard to say next to where Daniel
Radcliffe's
used to be.
Right. I think maybe they might have said that on set a few times.
You guys
I
just said, card
I just
was?
Said, where should I stand?
I just said asshole, which I think is perfect.
Shut your guessing hole.
This thinking isn't happening.
I can't. I don't. I have no idea what that card is.
Oh,
no, Snapping Turtles in on that corner.
Oh.
I don't remember.
Where'd we land? Oh, this one. Yeah. Boy, that's going to be a tricky one.
I don't remember.
That
okay,
might have been
on.
The one that we missed.
I'm rewinding.
No hints from the audience this time, or else this game is not going to exhibit its true nature.
The true nature is that we have
important.
Terrible memories.
Well, that's right. You would have been dead a long time ago. A player mass of 1 million people can always beat this game.
Yes, very.
We don't even know if they're writing this stuff down.
I actually think that, well, if people really wanted
to,
then in a 4-player game, it's just like, this is my section.
Right.
Remember
right.
These.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I mean, yeah, you can set aside all the...
What'd you say?
If you're allowed
to
share.
Being fat and stupid.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
And stupid.
We'll lose a castle then?
Yep, just lose the castles.
Boom.
Right, turn
we have one castle left.
Yep.
Oh god.
My
well,
turn.
The dragon's also
turn.
Almost dead.
No, that was
dead.
Your turn.
What,
no, that was
what are you doing
turn.
On your turn?
Whose turn was it?
Ricky's turn.
My turn now. I need a card, please.
Oh,
wait.
Still
no, wait. We just rolled an egg. So what are we doing now?
Oh, gotta move.
She gotta move away our attack.
Kill for 3.
3. 5.
Okay. That's progress. Ricky's card.
A lifetime of sadness. Where's that depression? Oh,
it's
depression.
It's blocked in.
Yeah, you can't put it next to depression.
You can put it as close to depression as possible.
Let's put it...
Less than caring thinks we're all going to die. But that shouldn't bother them.
Yeah, exactly. They're excited. And that's a good thing.
Let's put it right next to that yellow egg over there. Depression.
Or fat and stupid used to
sadness. Yeah, fat and stupid used to be over there.
Well, all right, your turn.
That's true. The audience can't give us hints if they forgot where we rolled.
Oh.
1-2. 2-1.
Oh.
Bam. Bam.
Hmm.
Anybody remember that one, or else we all die.
That's the one where you change everything to erase suspicion that you're gay.
Carefully
something like that one.
Your mannerism, so good.
That's
yes.
The one.
Yeah.
Yep.
That seems close enough.
That's good enough.
Got
Yay!
It.
Calculating every mannerism so as not to suggest homosexuality.
You're gonna move. Or shoot the dragon.
Whose turn is it?
Hey, shoot the dragon.
It's 5 HP.
I got no attack card.
All right.
Then
all
right. Then let's
move like
then move.
One.
Well, you can throw attack cards to somebody else if you have them for them.
Or you can move and get more cards.
I mean, yeah, moving and getting more cards.
Is this a one movement or two?
That is a 2 movement.
And you
so
have
you
one free.
A total of 3.
Yeah.
Can I move
3
that
steps.
Yellow?
Yeah. What color are you?
Blue.
Yes.
Blue. Yeah.
You're blue. Yeah. So that's 3 way.
Oh yeah.
Yeah,
notice how we haven't prohibited people from moving through the same space as other people and all that's crazy. Why would you make games that make it so hard to do stuff? When easy is
good?
I'm good.
Your turn.
Hard enough. Difficult enough.
Teaching a robot to love.
Aww.
Aww. Why?
Okay.
I really want to have sex with a robot.
Put
and
that
I want to
next
genuinely
to
love
depression
that.
One.
That's not depression.
Well, whatever that
I've
one is.
I've seen her
there.
Twice.
I haven't seen her.
Oh, it's good.
Roll.
It's good.
Really good.
3-1.
Yeah. 3-1. Oh, it blows up.
Wait, egg. no, sorry, I counted wrong.
Nope.
Hey, egg.
Okay.
Egg bro.
Hmm.
You have 5 points?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay.
got any points?
I can't even move to get to a thing. Who's blue?
I'm blue.
There's some stuff.
Sharing. Wow, 2 points of sharing. That was a sad turn. All right.
All right, Emily.
Okay. Blackface.
Blackface.
Wow. Is that the racism corner up there?
Sure.
Yeah. The Asians. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. All right.
That blows up.
Well, it is only a 6x6 grid, but we're definitely using the board.
Yeah.
We are using the hell out of it.
This board is used, as things are in Cards Against Humanity often.
Yes. Can I just play one?
Wait a second. Did you roll this?
One, three.
Oh, shoot.
Let's talk about that then.
Is that Florida? Sunshine and Rainbows.
That sounds like a good guess.
Sounds like a good
guess.
For the
sunshine
game.
Sunshine and Rainbows.
Florida.
It's Florida. No.
The last castle is destroyed.
The Minority Report is correct. It's Florida. The castle wins. The castle dies. The dragon wins.
Been killed by
dragon wins with 5 hit points.
You're so close.
Really How many did you have in your hand to kill?
Just
that. Oh, just two.
Well, I can now no longer say that I haven't designed a co-op game.
You have designed a co-op game.
Yeah.
The co-opiest.
That's the kiss. The co-opiest came out.
We made a game.
I can smell the co-op from here.
And what was the name of this game again?
I don't think we were calling it Mr. Dragon Bro, but I think we can do better.
I kind of like Egg Roll.
Egg Roll.
Hashtag slash suck it, Trebek. Dragon. Something like that.
Then we can do Egg Roll, and Mr. Dragon Bro could be the tagline. Yes. That makes sense.
No, none of that makes sense. No, I think Mr. Dragon Roll.
Mr. Dragon Roll.
Right. I like that number from Cheap Roll. Ass Games.
Yeah, but Dragon Roll is not too bad.
Dragon Roll.
Right? It sounds like a piece of sushi.
Makes me hungry. That's on theme.
Suro Bird Against Humanity. Well, we have to incorporate the names of all the games, though, so we have to call it...
Suro Mage Against Humanity Loot.
Humanity's Loot. Yeah, I like it.
I'm not upset. All right.
I'm a fan of Dragon Roll. I'm going to stick with that.
I like
that.
Okay, cool. We made
a game.
All right,
kids. We made a game. We named it, and we played it, and it was fun.
Yes. Tony, y'all have any game notes after playing it, a design comments or anything like that?
That was the best game ever, and I look forward to being your newest employee.
I actually liked the part.
We should talk about that.
Where the board was sort of separated into the four quadrants, and so we just sort of naturally like had things move into different corners. I liked the memory part of it, even though I have a terrible memory. Mm-hmm. So, I don't know. I liked that part of it. And the eggs falling was kind of fun.
I think the special card is too OP.
Oh, yeah. Right.
That's
yeah,
way too OP.
That's true. We haven't decided what the specials do.
It needs a lot of
value. I know what they do. They come out.
Yeah.
But that's always my, this is how Paul and I interact. Yeah, right? He's like, you know, specials would make this game better. And I'm like, no!
Take them out!
Take them all out!
They fix this problem. You're like, nope, those don't
Those problems exist because of fundamental mechanics that must be changed.
Do y'all have any game notes after watching it played a few times?
Go.
We've been making them as you go.
Okay.
Like, we've been saying, we added a rule of minimum egg count because we had a different experience playing with the AI because he was adding eggs but not doing it.
Right.
But we already kind of have a maximum egg count just by the pieces, so we might as well have a minimum.
Yeah, I think we'd want to figure out better what happens if there's only three people with the four tokens.
Yeah, we need to figure out how an AI player really ought to behave. I think we could do better at giving him something to do.
Right.
Well, thank you everyone for liking the show. That's great.
Yeah, thanks for watching.
I'm really glad that you like the show.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah, my new employee wants me to tell you all that I'm going to kickstart a strategy board game, the exact opposite of this. on April 19th, I'm doing a Kickstarter for a game called TAC, which is by Patrick Rothfuss and myself. It's out of his books.
Cool.
I got to write the rules for a game that he made up without the rules. And this is my travel set that is always with me starting today. I just finished these today.
I'm proud of you.
Thank you. And I brought them so I could talk about them.
Super good assistant.
I'm also proud of you.
I guess my pitch is that it's your fault the newest Smash Up expansion just came out.
Say it louder, Paul.
It's your fault. The newest Smash Up expansion just came out. You should go get it.
Spend money, buy that thing.
What are the armies in It's Your Fault?
The armies in It's Your Fault, it was actually voted by our fans. We did polls, and their choices fought against each other, and then I had to design whatever they came up with.
Nice.
But it's sharks, superheroes, Greek myths, and dragons. So they actually came up with good things.
Do the dragons drop lethal eggs full of cards?
They raise things.
They should drop eggs full of cards.
Well, you do have to remember Cards Against Humanity cards while you're playing, so that's...
Yeah, Elecki says Pat and I will have a panel on TAC at Emerald City Comic Con next week. We are actually going to play an exhibition game for the audience, so they'll get to watch.
Awesome.
They'll get to watch what the table talk is like in that game. We did that recently at another con, and it was really fun to watch.
Yeah.
So I'm told. It was also fun to do.
It was funny, exactly.
You but know, I mean, Pat's really about the one upsmanship in that game. Like, you don't play your power piece until you have to. Like, oh, you had to play your power piece. You suck, right? Or whatever.
Right.
And I was faking him out with, like, I saw he had an obvious win. I would play somewhere else and then not take my finger off it and then go, well, and take it back again.
That's fun to watch. That was
fun. Yeah. Oh, and Emerald City Comic Con is when?
It is next week.
Next weekend, I think, right?
So Saturday at 11 a.m.
Cool. Well, thanks so much for coming on the show. I think that's all we got for this
That's
week.
All we got for tonight, but stick around because we're going to be playing Rock Band in a little bit.
Oh, fun.
Thank you so much, you guys.
You have time
for coming.
I need to play
Rock
Band. You have time to show them how to play drums?
Absolutely.
Did you bring your entire drum kit? He has a Rock Band drum kit, seriously.
Wow. I do have the tools, yeah.
Cool.
Not the talent.
All right, well, thank you so much for tuning into Grab Bag. We have come up with a very interesting game today, and stick around. Come back next week for another episode of Grab Bag. All right, goodbye. Shut it down, Joe.
Shut it down, Joe.
Shut it down, Joe.